Mike Patrick along with Mike Gottfried. It's great to have you with us. South Carolina comes into this game 2-1, and oh, what a difference from a year ago when a five-game losing streak led to a player insurrection. Coach Sparky Woods survived that and even prospered, but that was after he put Steve Tannehill in as starting quarterback.
Mike, Steve Tannehill is not your conventional quarterback. Statistically, he's completing less than 50% of his passes. Technique-wise, he's a little rough, but those are things you can improve. But two words really sum up Steve Tannehill. He wins. He has fun playing the game at quarterback. He has confidence, and he makes the players around him play above their ability.
Now, Bill Curry brings the Kentucky team in here right now that's 1-2. They came within 3 seconds of upsetting highly regarded Florida. Then they floundered last week against Indiana. If they're going to bounce back from those two losses, they're going to have to do it, Mike, without their best wide receiver, maybe their best running back, and at least at the beginning, their starting quarterback.
Well, we were told before the game that Pookie Jones would not play. I watched him in warm-ups, and I think he will play. And if Pookie Jones can play, it'll be a big boost. But if he doesn't play, Antonio O'Farrell, the backup quarterback, will be the starter. Now, he took all the snaps in spring practice because Pookie Jones was playing baseball. If he is the quarterback, then look for Kentucky to run the option offense out of the stack eye. Try to develop the run. Also, you'd expect if your second-team quarterback's starting, your defense must respond, force some big plays, and turn it up a notch.
The Wildcats take the field, hoping to get their first win of the year in the Southeastern Conference. We'll be back with the opening kickoff in a moment.
Lennox Lewis. Has there ever been a heavyweight fighter so powerful, so brutal, so British?
Tea time, Mr. Lewis.
Lovely idea.
Jolly good shot to the head, sir.
Did you enjoy that combination?
Oh, yes. I'm certain I feel it tomorrow.
Oh, you flatter me.
See British boxing sensation Lennox Lewis take on Frank Bruno live, only on HBO.
So, will your mum be at the fight?
She never misses a bout. Now, was that one lump or two?
Why is Embassy Suites twice the hotel? First, you get a suite with two big rooms. Evening beverages are on the house, not on the bill. And our cook-to-order breakfast is free of charge. Obviously, this isn't your typical hotel. It's twice the room, twice the comfort, and twice the value. And it's only at Embassy Suites. Twice the hotel. Call 1-800-EMBASSY.
Williams Brice Stadium in Columbia, South Carolina. Mike Patrick and Mike Gottfried with you. And we have Kentucky and South Carolina tonight. As always, Dr. Jerry Punch with us on the sidelines. Jerry?
Thank you very much, Michael, and hello, everyone. You know, as documented, the Kentucky injury zone offense could put much of the burden of winning this football game on the Wildcat defense, led by senior middle linebacker Marty Moore. The three-year starter from Fort Thomas, Kentucky, led the SEC the past 2 years in total tackles. Head coach Bill Curry, who both coached and played with some of the all-time greats at that position for this young man, has many of those same qualities.
He's not interested in popularity. He's interested in performance. I've never seen a great leader, and especially a linebacker type, that wasn't like that. Mike Curtis, my roommate at Baltimore, was like that. Ray Nitschke, my teammate at Green Bay, was like that. Marty is like that. They really don't care what you think of them. They're going to get the job done, and if you're on the team, you better be getting your job done.
And getting that job done tonight means possibly stopping a very high-powered Gamecock offense that rolled up 631 yards right here last Saturday night. And Mike, that could take a Nitschke-like effort.
All right, Jerry, and he's certainly capable of doing it. That's Bill Curry in his fourth year at Kentucky. During that span, they've done all right at home, but had virtually no success on the road. Sparky Woods, in his fifth season as head coach, his winning percentage has been on the way up since Steve Tannehill became the starter. Kentucky will receive the opening kickoff, and Travis Harrison has it teed up at the 35. Harrison, a senior, 6 feet, 162, and a big crowd of more than 66,000 on their feet. Randy Wyatt, number three, and Alfonso Browning are deep to receive. Browning from the two. 20, 25, and near the 30.
Alfonso Harrison on the return.
Take a look at the McDonald's starting lineups. Antonio O'Farrell gets the started quarterback. He's an elusive runner, adept at directing the action. The question mark, his passing. Wingback Matt Riazzi, a former walk-on, could be a key to the running attack. Last season, he averaged more than 8 yards a carry. The only returning starter up front, junior Mark Askin. He's been starting at guard or tackle since he was a redshirt freshman. This is the stack eye. O'Farrell to throw on the first play. Browning, the wingback. And they surprised him on the first play, Mike Gottfried.
When you line up in the stack eye, it's a combination of the eye offense and the wishbone. South Carolina is so intent on stopping the option tonight. Kentucky took advantage of him on first down through the pass to Alfonso Browning off of the play fake of the option.
Browning's been averaging nearly 20 yards a catch this season. That was for 25. To the South Carolina 46-yard line. Donnell Gordon is the deep man of the eye. Instead, they'll give it to the fullback, Damon Hood. Take a look at the South Carolina defense. David Turnipseed missed last week with a viral infection. He was the conference defensive player of the week against Georgia. Outside linebacker Ernest Dixon, one of the team's leaders, a preliminary candidate for the Butkus Award. And strong safety Tony Watkins, an all-star candidate. He leads the team in tackles after taking that honor last year, too. Second and six. This time with three wide receivers in the ballgame. They go to the shotgun for O'Farrell. Comes pressure. He throws complete down to the 35-yard line. That should be good for another first down. And got it to his tight end, Corey Reeves, his first catch of the year. There's Pookie Jones. He is the starting quarterback. He couldn't play in the second half last week. He has a bad ankle and a bad arch on the other foot. So he's been hobbled, but in warm-ups, Mike, he looked good.
He looked good, and there's 10 days after this ball game before they play again. So if you do have a chance to put him in the game, I think he will play.
Of course, so far, there's no reason to fault O'Farrell. He's been perfect. Here he runs the action. The late toss got it out to Gordon, and Gordon down the sideline. Gordon pushed out of bounds inside the 10, maybe inside the 5. Norman Green finally got him, and Antonio Farrell, a very confident young man, has come in and done brilliantly on the opening series.
When you trade tapes and films, Arkansas in the film against South Carolina had success with the option, so Kentucky could look at that film, take some things off, and there's the pitch to Darnell Gordon, number 28. He waited just a little bit too long to get him the ball, but it still was a very successful play.
First and goal from the 3. Hood with the carry to the goal line. Kentucky trying to shock South Carolina on its opening possession. Let's go to Jerry Punch, Doctor.
And one of the shocks early, Michael, is a short huddle Kentucky's using. They're huddling sort of a combination between a regular huddle and a hurry-up offense. They're huddling about a yard and a half from the football, not giving South Carolina much time to make an adjustment. They turn out of the huddle, come into the line of scrimmage, and they're ready to snap the ball. Back upstairs.
Second and goal, inches away. Hood. No signal. Pushed back by the middle of the South Carolina defensive line. Pettiford in on the tackle. He's a senior, 6'1", 240 pounds.
When you play an option team in the goal line situation, you really have to gamble if you're South Carolina. Quarterback sneaks a possibility here. The dive to the fullback, and if they go outside, the option is very difficult to defend with goal line defense.
Got a sellout down here, third and inches. Kentucky goes 71 yards on the opening drive to score.
This is a called play from the start. It's an automatic give to the fullback. There's no read here at all. Usually you read the option, but this was a give to Damon Hood, number 31.
Juhai Leonoff on for the point after. And the young man out of Helsinki, Finland, knocks it through as Damon Hood has his first rushing touchdown of the season, and Kentucky has a touchdown lead.
Hey, here's your ding-ding, big fella. Huh? Yeah, here's Daddy's ding-ding.
Once you get a look at those two all-beef patties.
No, this is Daddy's.
Would you try some
special sauce, lettuce, cheese, piled fresh and hot on that sesame seed bun? You've got to have a Big Mac.
What you want is what you get at McDonald's today.
Even if you can afford some of life's luxuries, you still need a way to get them home. Which is why the Isuzu Trooper comes with a cavernous amount of cargo space. 90.2 cubic feet, to be exact.
850, a known bid 850. Marsha, sold to the gentleman in the blue blazer.
Plus, it's got a rather large towing capacity. The Isuzu Trooper, practically amazing.
Today, a woman needs a life insurance plan of her own.
State Farm sells life insurance from an agent who's there for you today and there tomorrow, too. You see, we start you outright with a plan specifically designed for a woman's needs, one that protects the people who count on you for so very much. And a State Farm agent will be there tomorrow, too, as your life changes, to keep that plan working for the people you love.
State Farm sells life insurance.
ESPN's Thursday Night CFA is brought to you by Isuzu, makers of incredible four-wheel drives, and by State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Kentucky shocking South Carolina early, 12:31 to go in the first quarter. We have had one possession, and South Carolina gives up a 71-yard, seven-play drive. Kentucky hit him with a couple of big ones, a 25-yard pass, a 32-yard run on the option.
Sometimes when you're the opposing team and you hear that the starting quarterback isn't going to play, you relax a little bit. And it looked like South Carolina relaxed a little bit on defense in the first series.
They better not relax from now on. That young man can play. Dan Thompson to kick to Bennett and Bridges. Corey Bridges at the 12. Fumbled it, got it back. And doesn't make it back to the 15 as he is swarmed under by white and blue jerseys. Take a look at the South Carolina offense. Brandon Bennett off to a great start. He scored the game winner against Georgia. He's averaging almost 100 yards a game. Senior tight end Matthew Campbell is a key to the running game with his blocking ability, and they want him more involved as a receiver, too. Vincent Dinkins started every game at left guard in 92. He was moved to center after this spring practice. Come out with a single setback, Rob DeBoer, the fullback, as Bennett goes in the slot. Play action by Tannehill. He's in trouble and he's sacked. Howard Carter, a 6'4 junior, fired, threw and dropped him.
Howard Carter's going to get a pass rush here. He didn't take the fake at all from Steve Tannehill. He just was on an inside rush, beats the block with a tackle for the first sack of the game.
Second and 18, back to the I formation. Bennett, the deep man in the eye. And Bennett will get the carry. Bennett to the 19-yard line. Brought down by Deuce Williams, the outside linebacker. Look at the Kentucky offense. Zane Bean should benefit from the 4-3 defense. The coaches are counting on him for big plays up front. Middle linebacker Marty Moore is an all-star. Butkus Award candidate. He's been the leading tackler in the SEC the last 2 years. And strong safety Marcus Jenkins, the Wildcats interception leader. He picked off three in the upset bid against Florida. Third and five after Bennett's run. Back to the slot formation. Pressured again, throws off balance, intended for Bennett and thrown out of bounds. Good coverage back there by the linebacker James Tucker, who comes in when they go to their nickel back.
Kentucky defense wants to force South Carolina in third and five or more yards on third down. They can be successful that way. South Carolina must get Brandon Bennett off running the football on the first two downs of every series. He has to have success for them to set up their play action passing game.
Marty Simpson is into punt. And Matt Riazzi waits at his own 40-yard line. Nice high kick. Riazzi, no fair catch. got away from the first man and picked up a couple of yards because of it. Coach, this offense, a lot of people haven't seen it. They call it a stack eye. Some people call it the eyeball.
Tommy Nugent, 1949, developed this. But what you have is an eye offense. Power runs inside off tackle. Then if you dislodge the two backs, you have the wishbone. That's the back that goes into position. That's the one at that position. So you have the wishbone and the eye combination.
Donnell Gordon, the deep man. And here's the end around to Sims. Got a couple of nice blocks. And Sims has a first down at the South Carolina 43-yard line. And Bill Curry pulling out the stops early.
Well, he has to. He's on the road, and South Carolina seems to be a little flat-footed on defense. Again, you worry about the option. You practice against it all week, and what does Kentucky do? They come back with a reverse to Sims, number 9. A good blocking by the Kentucky offensive line. That will slow down the pursuit of the South Carolina defense.
An excellent body control by quarterback Antonio O'Farrell, who was going down, didn't panic, and got the ball to his running back. Hood and Gordon are the split backs as they go to the shotgun. O'Farrell on the run, another completion to the South Carolina 37-yard line. Donnell Gordon made the catch. Norman Green made the tackle. Here is a quarterback who complained about his lack of playing time. He's got his chance tonight, and apparently he's not going to let go.
Well, he's making the best of it. Kentucky uses two different offenses, not only the eye bone, which is a combination of two, but the shotgun.
O'Farrell, 3 for 3, 38 yards. Hood, the fullback, very close to the first down sticks. When we met with O'Farrell the other night, he shows up, and I know you were shocked because he's wearing a South Carolina hat.
I asked him, I said, why do you have a South Carolina hat on? He says, listen, I wear the hat the week of the game of every team we're going to play. I want to make my players mad. And the first thought that came to my mind is, how did you get a Kent hat? And he said, my girlfriend called up Kent State and asked him to send us a hat. We got the hat, so I have every one of the 11 games.
He said, even if I only get 5 of my teammates fired up by doing it, it's worth it. It is a first down for Kentucky, already leading 7-0. O'Farrell runs the option again. He's clean. Horse collared as he got inside the 30, and it was Norman Green and Ron Neely who came up to hit him from their defensive back spot.
Alfonso Browning is the key back in this because he is going to be the load blocker in the stack eye. Watch number 86. He gets the block on the linebacker. That frees up Antonio O'Farrell.
Green has already been in on 5 tackles. It is 2nd and 5, Kentucky. Cut through and put him down. He missed last week with a viral infection.
All week, Miles Aldridge, the defensive coordinator, had his defense work against the option without a football. Because the quarterback will read it and put it in the belly of the fullback and then pull it out, he didn't want him to look for the football. He said, let's just go through our assignments and responsibilities.
3rd and 6. Kentucky sends 3 wide receivers to the near side. Pressure throw should have been complete right in the hands of Donnell Gordon, and he couldn't hold it. Watkins the closest defender, but that ball should have been complete.
It's right on the money, Mike.
James Flowers was the man who was putting the pressure on, and Juha Leona from Helsinki, Finland, who is 2 for 2 this year.
He's looking for somebody to hold the ball.
Yeah, that would help. And Matt Riazzi, the wingback, comes out. This will be 46 yards. Got a chance. Just missed it. So South Carolina defense stiffens and prevents another score.
Final question, ladies. How would you save the planet?
Tax credits for education. Aggressive environmental legislation. Which planet?
Why do pageants still grade on a curve?
Queen of the entire planet.
Try a less filling beer with a lot more taste. Bud Grimes. With a beer this different.
What a surprise.
It's no contest.
It's been our observation that where there's a popular car, there's a lease. And where there's a lease, there's one of these. And, well, here's ours, accompanied by the Fillmore String Quartet, who, by the way, would all fit very comfortably inside the Isuzu Trooper, seeing how it's probably the most spacious four-wheel drive around. Why, they could probably even add another member if they wanted to. Maybe not. The Isuzu Trooper and the Trooper lease, practically amazing.
Next Saturday, the Scarlet Knights of Rutgers tackle Joe Paterno's Nittany Lions. Live CFA football, Saturday, 7:30 p.m. on ESPN.
When you've made a mistake and the head coach is waiting for you on the sideline, it is one of the most unpleasant experiences in life. And Matt Riazzi, who was to be the holder on that field goal attempt, got out there late, and Bill Curry was laying for him on the sideline.
Curry asked him how much his ticket cost because he bought one and was watching the game.
South Carolina takes over at its own 29-yard line. They're in the eye. Bennett. Line hard up to the 35. Bennett, last week, the first South Carolina player ever to rush for 100 and get 100 receiving. That was last week against Louisiana Tech. I mean, that's just a remarkable performance.
This is their offense, Mike. If they can get Brandon Bennett moving early in the rushing game, then that opens up Steve Tannehill for his play-action passing game.
Of course, they've had some pretty good backs here. George Rogers among them, and when you come to the stadium, you come along. George Rogers drives, second and four. DeBoer, who was a pretty good running back himself, only gets a couple this time. Of course, the key focal point on this ball club is the young man with the long, flowing mane, Steve Tannehill. But I think all of us have been guilty on focusing on the things that he is different than everybody else. Because the kid is a winner. He loves playing the game. He gets a great kick out of it. And so what if he's got long hair? Third and a yard. Stanley Pritchett, number 49, is checked into the backfield with DeBoer. DeBoer will get the carry. Pritchett, a good lead block.
DeBoer.
And DeBoer, with second effort, got the first down.
I look forward to coming in and meeting Steve Tannehill because you read so many things about him. But what I've found since I've been here is a very confident quarterback that exudes it to his teammates. But also, I don't know of any college football player that's having as much fun as he is. He enjoys it, and he's always talking about we, us. I've never heard him say I, so he is a team player.
And he's a winner. First and 10. Bennett tried to make the cut outside, but wrapped up by John Collins, one of the strongest players on this team. So much, of course, has been written and said about Tannehill. We asked him what's the biggest misconception people have.
They think I'm the star. I want to be the big football hero, but really I just want our team to win. And, I think that's the most important thing to me is team and winning. And that is definitely what gets overlooked.
Well, not really, Steve. They don't overlook the fact you're winning. That's what's made an icon here in Columbia, South Carolina, second and 11. Draw.
Took
a shot from Deuce Williams, number two. That's his real name, Deuce, D-U-C-E. Last year he wore number three. Well, that's trice, so you don't want that. You change the number two.
Well, now they've forced South Carolina into third and long, and that's where Kentucky wants the South Carolina offense. They do not want to gamble against the play-action pass, so this is what they want.
Monty Means checks in as a wide receiver. He's number 80 along with Chris Alford, number 17 on third and 10. They both come to the near side. Tannehill trying to step up in the pocket, and he is sacked. Billy Lofton, number 70, made the tackle.
John Collins on the stop. Fourth down.
That's the game plan for Kentucky, to get him in third and long. Number 70, Billy Lofton's going to work up the field. They get a good push out of their defensive line. Billy Lofton, who's an outstanding pass rusher, does a spin move and is able to come back in on Steve Tannehill.
Mike, this is not the same Kentucky team that was mugged a week ago at Indiana.
No, when I watched the tape, Indiana just bloodied their nose. I mean, they went right at him with the eye offense. Bill Mallory just really made it a tough physical football game.
Marty Simpson with a short kick to Riazzi. Doesn't again signal for the fair catch. Takes a lot of guts and gets a couple of yards out of it. A return of two after a punt of 34. Ernest Dixon makes the tackle. Hope you'll join us every Saturday at 11:30 in the morning Eastern, College Game Day, with Chris Lee and Craig previewing all the big games and stories. At 12:30, we'll go to the Big Ten. Number 23, Wisconsin, takes on the undefeated Hoosiers of Indiana. Then at 7, the Residence Inn College Football Scoreboard Show. And then at 7:30, it's off to Happy Valley as the 8th-ranked Penn State Nittany Lions host the Scarlet Knights of Rutgers. And believe me, folks, the only people who call it Happy Valley are the home folks. The visiting team doesn't.
Had a few games there. You're right.
O'Farrell under pressure. And get it out to the 33-yard line. We talked about Tannehill being so confident. This young man, a couple of weeks ago, really beefed about his lack of playing time, says we ought to change the offense and throw more. He says, I'll challenge anybody. He can play.
Here's what the shotgun does for you. No one in the middle. One player for South Carolina, and he'll get back in the hook area. And when you have a mobile quarterback now, he's able to get inside, pick up a few yards, put himself in a second and about four-yard situation.
He was the New York State Player of the Year when he was a senior. And this looks like a busted play. The entire backfield, except O'Farrell, went to the right. He went to the left. Let's check in with Jerry Punch. Doctor?
Junior offensive tackle Aaron Purdy was up off the field in the previous series behind me. Now, his official diagnosis is a sublux right patella. That basically is a dislocated kneecap. They have it taped and iced. He may be back, but it's doubtful. Back upstairs.
And Chris Page, who is also coming off an injury, back in, third and five. Wyatt and Riazzi are the backs, and now Wyatt goes to a slot. O'Farrell into the flat, and it's dropped again. The only two incomplete passes for Kentucky tonight have been dropped. And Damon Hood couldn't hold that one. Ernest Dixon, the outside linebacker, got penetration on the play.
The strategy for South Carolina now simple. When Kentucky goes to the shotgun offense, heat him up and blitz the outside linebacker, Ernest Dixon, number 40.
South Carolina has obviously made some adjustments on the fly that are working. Nichols is in the punt.
Nichols.
To take it. Return of 6 yards after a punt of 39. On the Kentucky sideline, a great player in the NFL, really an undersized center. He has coached at Georgia Tech, built them out of nothing, and went to Alabama. And now in his fourth year at Kentucky, Sparky Woods, his fifth season at South Carolina. Mike, two teams trying to get to the upper echelon of the SEC. This is a big game and a big year for them.
It is. I think both teams look at this game as a must-win if they're to go to a bowl game and contend for the SEC title in their division.
Tannehill changing the play on first and 10. Straight back to throw. Thought he had a hitch. Now goes with a slant, and it's incomplete. Tried to hit a split end, Terrell Harris, and he couldn't hold it. Second string offensive line is in for South Carolina as a group.
They've won a rest their first team offensive line, but the way the offense has been moving, this is, you sometimes wonder if you need to do it on the third series. Their offense hasn't been out there very long.
They only have 15 yards in total offense so far. Kentucky has racked up 104, most of it on that initial drive. Tannehill, here's the blitz. Nice job to block and pick it up, and Tannehill. Jimmy Hill throws complete at the 48. Then Harris fumbled the ball, but they'll say he's down. It'll be a first down, a gain of 13, and Terrell Harris has his sixth catch of the year.
What really makes this play is Steve Tannehill. There's a lot of pressure from Kentucky. Now, they bring a linebacker, bring Deuce Williams, number two, but you see, he's able to move to the left. That's something you don't teach a quarterback. He has a feel and a presence. Good block by number 31, Rob DeBoer.
DeBoer, the only man in the backfield now, as Bennett goes to the slot. Tannehill straight back to throw. Nice catch by Bennett. The ball was behind him. He had to turn and make the grab. A gain of 19.
Sometimes it's not pretty from number 18, Steve Tannehill, but he gets the job done. Players just believe he can win. Real slow developing play, and he really doesn't have a lot on this ball. Kentucky just did not break on the football. The defensive backs, Brandon Bennett with the reception.
And the Kentucky secondary is the strongest point of their defense. First and 10, South Carolina's best drive. And Tannehill needs a timeout with 1:51 to go in the first quarter. A minute 51 to go in the period. If you join us late, Kentucky took the opening kickoff, had a couple of big plays, and behind a sophomore quarterback who had never started a game before, they go 71 yards and get the opening touchdown. And Mike, you were talking about Tannehill in the open of the broadcast, the fact that he's completed less than 50% of his passes. This offense is not an offense designed to get you a lot of completions and to get up around 60%.
It really isn't. It's an eye offense with a power running game, and that's what you have to establish. Where I think Steve Tannehill is really tough as a quarterback to defend is his play-action passing game, where he'll fake to Brandon Bennett and Rob DeBoer and roll out and throw the football to his tight end and crossing routes. Kentucky wants to come into this game. There's Art Wilkins, the offensive coordinator of South Carolina. Kentucky wants them to drop back and throw the football. That's what they feel like they have the best chance to defend.
It is a first and 10 for South Carolina. They came in heavily favored over Kentucky after just pounding lumps on Louisiana Tech a week ago. Zane Bean getting ready to come after Tannehill. DeBoer barely got the handoff, tries to go outside, and he is swamped. First man there was Darrell Kahn. Let's go to Jerry Punch. Doctor?
Gentlemen, as good as Steve Tannehill is, you got to remember he is still just a sophomore, and sophomores can make mistakes. The problem they have here on the South Carolina sideline, Tannehill having trouble understanding the hand signals from Rich Bisaccia, the running back coach, who signals in the plays. So when in doubt, you call timeout, and that's what Tannehill did just a moment ago. Back upstairs.
All right, Jerry, second and eight. It is a game of communication, isn't it? Tannehill with a short drop, then he's in trouble. Tried to sidearm it to Mike Reddick, who comes in as a pass receiver. Hasn't rushed the ball from scrimmage in about a year.
Kentucky's doing a good job of disguising defenses. They're trying to talk Steve Tannehill into some different things before the snap of the ball. And then after he makes those decisions, there's a lot of movement by the Kentucky defense.
Tannehill, 2 out of 5, 32 yards. Third and 8. Good protection this time. Tannehill throws short, complete to Harris. Trying to keep his balance. Kahn couldn't get him down. And then he swarmed over well short of the first down at the Kentucky 28-yard line. Harris just couldn't get both feet under him to run at full speed after he made the catch underneath. James Tucker will get credit for that tackle.
Kentucky wants some movement out of their defensive people. You see the little X stunt here where Zane Bean works outside and works inside, but the South Carolina offensive line picked that stunt up. Mike Archer, the defensive coordinator.
And they're just not big enough to line up against you man-to-man and push you back into the backfield. They will go for the field goal with Reed Morton, who's at 4 out of 5 this year. It will be a 45-yard attempt. His long is 42. Line drive kick, and it's wide. Had the distance, but barely missed the upright. So both teams have missed a field goal early in the quarter. Be with us tomorrow afternoon at noon Eastern. We have Davis Cup tennis for you. Qualifying round match between the United States and the Bahamas. One the United States has to win to stay in the World Group for 94. Two singles matches for you. Andre Agassi will go against Roger Smith and Mal Washington against Mark Knowles. All the action takes place at Charlotte, North Carolina, and right here on ESPN.
Mike, Kentucky needs to go back to the option. That was really a successful for him in the first drive.
Hood, the fullback.
Damon Hood.
Across the 30 to the 31-yard line. Ronnie Smith, one of the inside linebackers, made the stop. And that will be the last play of the first quarter. And a surprising one it is, with underdog Kentucky 1-15 on the road again under Bill Curry, leading by a touchdown.
Okay, pull away from the curb and take a left at the end of the block.
Yes, sir.
Is this a new trooper?
Yes, sir. It's my mom's.
Tell you what, take a right instead.
Yes, sir.
If ever there was an excuse for driving a little bit out of your way, this is it.
Very nice.
Wait, I didn't get to parallel park.
You're right.
The Isuzu Trooper. Practically amazing.
Very nice.
Cowboys invented Wrangler cowboy cut jeans for those relaxing moments when you just want to stretch out and unwind. Wrangler, the Western original.
In America, your car is not just something you own. It's a part of your life. To give your car complete protection, Texaco has developed Havoline Formula 3 Motor Oil. With not one, but three kinds of protection against heat stress, starting friction, and engine dirt. Havoline Formula 3. Add more life to your car.
Go ahead. Make a wish. Then share it with your Allstate agent, who knows planning makes wishes come true, and who can outline a life insurance plan to assure family security and college funding and a comfy retirement are in the stars for you. So make your wish and trust it to your Allstate agent, who wants to be your agent for life.
The press calls it the show to watch.
I'm hooked into the biggest crime family in the city.
From now on, it's every man for himself.
He whacked my partner, and I want him.
NYPD Blue is this season's only groundbreaking series.
Come to Mama, baby.
I will hold you in contempt.
And I hold you in contempt. You ought to be ashamed of yourself. I admit I have feelings for you, but it's not going to work out for us.
I'm not going to take that for an answer. We can make it work out.
I don't want to be alone tonight.
I want you to kill him.
NYPD Blue on ABC. Viewer discretion advised.
Way back in 1947, cowboys designed Wrangler cowboy cut jeans to be comfortable in the saddle. Or out of it. Wrangler, the Western original.
We start the second quarter in Columbia, South Carolina, with Kentucky leading the Gamecocks 7-0.
Mike, when you run an option offense, you must win first down, 4-plus yards on first down, because you want to be in third and short, 6 out of 9 for Kentucky. They're winning the battle on first down.
And they've got a winning quarterback with sophomore Antonio O'Farrell. 2nd and 7. O'Farrell trying to run the option, and he stumbled.
You like to get penetration against the option. Defensive tackles were able to do that and trip up Antonio O'Farrell.
3rd and 9. O'Farrell is listed at 5'10", 180. But forget it. Total yards so far, Kentucky with 105. Last week against Indiana, they only had 29 offensive yards in the first half. O'Farrell to the shotgun. Screen. Hood trying to weave his way around. Blockers taken out at the 35-yard line. Ernest Dixon read it well from his outside linebacker spot.
The center has a real difficult job when he centers for the shotgun. You see, he'll look at the quarterback, and when he sees him lift his leg, now his his eyes will go to who he's going to block, and it's just a snap to the quarterback, a blind snap.
Nichols is in to punt to Frank Adams, who waits back inside his own 30. Nichols came in tonight averaging 38-1. This first punt was 39. This is a beauty. High hanger. Adams at the 29. Fumbled the football and got it back at the 25.
Frank Adams.
Steve Tannehill, of course, installed as the starter after the player revolt last year when they were 0-5. He is 7-2 as a starter. The 0-5 streak, the beginning of last year, they couldn't do anything on offense. And Tannehill came in. Look at the production in points. Doubled, 50% gain in total yards, and doubled the passing yard.
It's important, Brandon Bennett. You started here running the football.
Bennett's the deep man in the eye. Play action to it. Tannehill deep down the middle, incomplete. Intended for Boomer Foster, his tight end, and number 17, Van Hiles, a freshman, stuck a shoulder in there and broke it up.
Boomer Foster, number 87, when you play against a two-deep secondary, you like to try to get the ball down the middle of the field about 15 to 25 yards to your tight end, but it was just off the fingertips of Boomer Foster, but that play's there.
On second and 10, Bennett. Slips one tackle. Moore was waiting for him at the 30 and got some help. Don Robinson, the first man to hit him.
He's an exciting running back, and when he touches the football, he has a chance to make some big things happen. He makes people miss, and he benefits from his fullback, Rob DeBoer, number 31, who's an outstanding blocker.
Bennett, 4 carries, 23 yards. It's already the 13th, making the 12th all-time rusher. He only needed 5 yards coming in to get that. And just a junior out of Taylor's, South Carolina. 3rd and 5. 4-man rush. Tannehill steps up in the pocket, throws short to Bennett. Stanley Pritchett, the fullback. He got 15. And Tannehill took what he had.
That's what Steve Tannehill does best. He has a good feel, first of all, for the rush. Second of all, he looks to his primary receiver. He ducks under, and now he's able to dump the ball off to Stanley Pritchard, who's probably the second or third receiver in the progression.
Bennett and Pritchett will remain in at running back, 1st and 10 from the 45. Bennett on the toss sweep, no place to go. Moore had him around the ankles and brought him down. Gain of about a yard. Wright also came up to help out.
Marty Moore is an active linebacker. All the Kentucky coaches raved about him. Mike Archer said, if my son grows up like Marty Moore, he'll be successful. He's the middle linebacker, number 45, and when you're in the 4-3 defense, it's hard to block the middle linebacker. He has to make plays.
2nd and 9. Tannehill with a quick drop, throws short, incomplete. Foster couldn't hold it to tight end. Pass a little low and behind him. Foster with only 2 catches this year.
Kentucky's trying to blitz Steve Tannehill to make him throw the little 5-yard pass. They figure if he throws a 5-yard pass and they're able to come up and make the tackle, no damage done. They do not want to give him a long time back there to throw the deep ball.
Archer, of course, the former head coach at LSU. Means comes in as a wide receiver. 4-man rush. Tannehill steps up, throws short. That ball looked like it may have hit the ground, but it's going to be short of a first down anyway. Means made the catch.
That's their strategy, Mike. They're going to put pressure on him, make him throw the short ball, and short of the first down, force him to punt the football. Good strategy by Mike Archer.
Simpson comes on to punt. Homegrown product out of Columbia. And Riazzi will go deep.
Kentucky.
11 minutes, 19 seconds to go. First half, Kentucky holding to a surprising 7-0 lead. And end over end. Riazzi disdains the fair catch again. This is a tough kid.
He's takes it to the 19. Gee-many Christmas. He's going to handle everything.
As long as he can catch him and take a hit and not cut it loose, that's fine. 7-0 Kentucky.
ESPN's Thursday Night CFA is brought to you by the new Dodge, a division of the Chrysler Corporation.
And that's the locker of the legendary George Rogers. And there he is. The man ran like a truck going downhill with a clutch in. I mean, you got in his way, you got planted. 5,200 yards rushing. Incredible college football player. Of course, won the Heisman here at South Carolina. Kentucky takes over. O'Farrell in the shotgun. Hit him from behind. Got away. Won't get away the second time. There's the ball. South Carolina has it. Ernest Dixon comes up with a fumble.
Tough to run two offenses. First of all, you're asking your linemen to block the option. Then second of all, you go to the shotgun offense, and now you're telling me you want them to be pass blockers. Stacy Evans, number 93, is going to get in, get a hand on the football and cause the fumble.
South Carolina goes to work after the turnover. Not much there.
Here's another look at the fumble. You have a young quarterback. You want to pressure him. Stacy Evans causes the fumble. Eric Sullivan recovers.
Evans, a transfer from North Greenville Junior College, and there's Bill Curry talking to O'Farrell. It's the only mistake he's made tonight. Second and 10, Gamecocks from the 15-yard line. Bennett, nice hole. Marty Moore came up and filled it after a gain of about three.
Marty Moore on the stop.
Moore, 6'1", 238. Bennett, 6 feet, 198. Moore won that battle.
Third down in South Carolina's offense. The tight end becomes very important. Matthew Campbell, 6'5 frame, so he's a good target for Steve Tannehill.
Inside the 20 this year, 13 times. They have 8 touchdowns, and Tannehill will take his second time out of the first half on a big play. Third and 6 with 9:58 to go in the half. Carolina 7-0, and now for tonight's U.S. Army student of the game. He is Kentucky linebacker Marty Moore, a vocational education major with a 3.2 grade point average, two-time member of the All-SEC academic team. Also extremely active in community service, participating in the Big Buddy program, as well as being a guest speaker for various elementary and high schools in the Lexington area. He has done it all in spite of the fact that he has dyslexia. Still has a 3.2 grade point average. We didn't have that excuse. We just weren't real bright.
Speak for yourself, Michael.
I am. Third and 6 at the Kentucky 11. South Carolina trying to tie the score. Tannehill in the flat. Diving for the sticks. And it looks like he's just short. James Tucker pushing him out of bounds.
Well, Mike Riddick is their possession receiver on third down. They were number 25. They're going to bring both receivers from the outside inside. Easy throw for Steve Tannehill, just short of the first down.
Fourth and 1, and Sparky Woods says we're going to go for it. Bennett is back in as the deep man in the eye, and they'll stack the backfield.
Sometimes it's good to go outside on this short yardage play. Unless they get a good spot, I don't think he made it.
John Collins and Matt Noose hit him at the line of scrimmage, and they did not get it. What a stand by Kentucky.
John Collins, number 92. His brother, Sonny, was the all-time leading rusher at Kentucky. They're from Madisonville, Kentucky. But you watch, the lead blocker really doesn't get up in time, and John Collins just got penetration on Rob DeBoer.
Man, they just threw him down at the line of scrimmage. Kentucky had a defensive stand that way last week against Indiana early in the ball game, but couldn't take advantage of it. This time the advantage is obvious. South Carolina can't score. O'Farrell, who fumbled on the last possession, comes out. Hood, the fullback, trying to get some breathing room. pounds it out near the seven.
Now the problem for Bill Curry on offense for Kentucky is you have your second team quarterback in there. You want to run the option. You're backed up inside the five. Do you take the gamble right now? I think you do on the road. You take and run the option. But what you're worried about is when you're running in practice, it's different. When you come into the game, the mesh of the option is something new for that young quarterback to read.
Second and eight.
Is right there to number 28, Donnell Gordon. He just didn't handle it.
Yeah, I tell you what, it was a little bit of a line drive pitch, but you're right. There's no excuse for missing that ball. Another huge break for South Carolina. They failed to convert on the last one. This time it's first and goal up the five.
Well, you can bet Bennett's going to be the player here.
Bennett on the toss behind Pritchett. Bennett to the goal line. Marty Moore. John Collins prevented the touchdown.
Number 39, Steve Pritchard. You need a good eye back to block the lead block for your tailback. Number 39 with a key kickout block. Brandon Bennett read it, tucked the ball inside.
Second and goal from a foot away. Of Steve Tannehill celebrating with the rest of the crowd as Bennett goes over the top for the touchdown. It is as loud here as any place in the country.
Stadium moved a little bit too.
It did. Reed Morton will come on for the point after, so South Carolina converts one of two fumbles.
The offensive line of South Carolina with good movement and of course put the ball in the hands of number 33, Brandon Bennett.
Morton, who is perfect on points after this year, now 9 for 9. And South Carolina, with 8 minutes and 28 seconds to go in the first half, comes back on Brandon Bennett's touchdown after a fumble. On the sideline, as Kentucky has recovered two fumbles deep in South Carolina territory. That time they converted. And they've tied this one up at 7 with 8:28 to go in the first half. Mike Patrick, Mike Gottfried, and Dr. Jerry Punch with you. A good ball game from Columbia, South Carolina. Kentucky, a team that has won 1 of 15 on the road under Bill Curry, with a strong start here, but they have fumbled it away on their last two possessions. Wyatt and Browning await the kick of Travis Harrison. Got all of this one. 3 yards deep in the end zone, and they'll keep it there. Our Thursday night series will continue next week. It all begins at 7:40 Eastern with the weekend kickoff show. Chris Lee and Craig preview all the action on the weekend. Then we'll be in San Diego as the great Marshall Faulk will lead the San Diego Aztecs against the Bruins of UCLA. Been that game the last couple of years, and what a pleasure it is to watch Marshall Faulk run the football.
Fine running back.
Look at the difference in the total yardage. Kentucky minus one in the second quarter after a big first half. Randy Wyatt is in at tailback, the deep man in the eye. They'll run the action. O'Farrell hangs on to it and goes between two tacklers up to the 29-yard line. Tough little guy, Mike.
Well, you like to get, Darrell Dickey talked about, he wants 50-50 offense. He wants a balanced attack. That's Darrell Dickey. What you want to do for Antonio O'Farrell now is give him something that he can have some success with. That was an option probably called so the quarterback would keep the football.
A young man who does not lack confidence, and certainly off what we have seen tonight, he certainly deserves to be confident about his ability. Give it to the tailback. Browning goes the other, excuse me, me, the wing back, and he goes the other way across the 35 to the 36-yard line. Ron Neely came up from the corner to make the tackle, and that's the first time we've seen that play.
Misdirection played and try to hold the defense. They have Kentucky has to find a way to block Ernest Dixon, number 40. He's been a big playmaker early in this game.
It's a first and 10 at the 36. Wyatt Browning and Hood from the back to the front, the men in the stack eye. Pitch, and that was forward. Wyatt made the catch. That should go down to the books as a forward pass. And O'Farrell did a nice job getting rid of the ball.
South Carolina is trying to force the action and make him make the wrong decision.
Well, I don't think he's made one yet, Mike. I mean, he fumbled the ball once, but that was just a good hit from behind.
If you're coaching over here and paying your groceries, I'll tell you what, you're worried about those pitches.
Second and 8, Wyatt straight ahead. Maybe a yard. David Turnip, seat number 91, waiting for him. Mike, this stack eye offense, this is the kind of thing that can disguise some faults in your ball club, can it?
It really can. If you're building a program, Jerry DiNardo, for instance, at Vanderbilt, stack eye coach, Bill McCartney when he's at Colorado, they use this. It can help you to get some better players in to open up your offense a little bit more.
Third and 5. Three wide receivers to the far side. Four-man rush. O'Farrell with time. Throws complete. Got a first down. Alfonso Browning, the wingback, and O'Farrell, 5 out of 7 passing. That was for 17 yards.
Norman Green on the south. First down.
David Turnessy, number 91, is going to make a move inside, then come outside. But Barry Rich, 55. Mark Askin, 76. Pick up the movement.
Good grab by Browning. He has been the big play man the last couple of years for Kentucky, averaging nearly 20 yards a catch. First and 10, Wildcats, South Carolina 42. O'Farrell with the keeper. Got excellent balance, dives into the 38-yard line. Surprising Kentucky. Tied with South Carolina at Williams Brice Stadium. More than 66,000 on hand here in the Thursday night. 6 minutes to go. First half of play. Mike Patrick, Mike Gottfried, and Dr. Jerry Punch, our entire ESPN crew with you. And Kentucky has been impressive on offense. South Carolina has scored only as the result of a turnover. The pitch to Antonio O'Farrell looks pretty calm for a young man who's never started a game before.
He really is calm, but I'll tell you, those pitches have to worry you if you're coaching. But here's the alley player against the option. The safety, Norman Green, has to come up and support the run. Look for a play-action pass off of the option to try to take advantage of Norman Green when he comes up so fast.
Green's been in on 9 tackles in that run support tonight. First and 10, again, Kentucky. Back in at tailback, Donnell Gordon, number 28. O'Farrell, double clock, almost had it intercepted. Brooks had it right in his hands, and Aubrey Brooks out of Sumter, South Carolina, just couldn't hold it. That's the first bad throw tonight for O'Farrell.
He threw it too short. Antonio O'Farrell was looking for the tight end, and when you run the option, everybody's going to come up to try to stop the option. Now watch a tight end come off the ball, Corey Reeves. It's covered pretty well by Norman Green. There's just no place to throw the football.
Second and 10 with 5 minutes and 34 seconds to go in the half. Kentucky with the ball at the South Carolina 31. Pressure on O'Farrell. Throws for his tight end. Throws short and incomplete to Corey Reeves, the junior from Corbin, Kentucky.
Maynard Caldwell, number 89, said earlier when they go to the shotgun, Kentucky, South Carolina is going to try to heat them up with pressure.
Upper West Side, Chuck Howard.
And Aaron Purdy, the starting left tackle for Kentucky, is out for the ball game. He had a partial dislocation of his kneecap. Third and 10. O'Farrell throws to Browning. Browning diving forward to the 24-yard line. Boy, they love it to get to that guy. Now we see why.
The middle screen, Bobby Bowden made famous at Florida State. On the road, you take the field goal.
It's fourth and three, and the field goal team comes on. Leonoff has already missed one. He is 2 for 3 for the year. This will be from 41. Out of the hold of Riazzi. And they didn't get it off in time, I believe. Looked like the play clock went to zero.
Oh, delay on the offense. 5 yards, take your spot.
That is fourth down. The first penalty of the ball game, and that is, I mean, Kentucky on the road with all this noise, that's great. South Carolina has been penalized all over the place this year. That's great for them. What it's, who it's tough on is Leonoff, because now we go back to 46 yards. That's the distance he missed from the first time.
5 yards further, a little more time to think about it. It's tough on the kicker.
Young man who had never seen football until he came to this country from Finland as an exchange student. Kick, and he missed again, wide left. And there is a huge difference between 41 and 46 yards. Let's check in with Jerry Punch. Jerry?
Thank you very much, Michael. I am with Susan and Art Tannehill, all the way from Altoona, Pennsylvania. The 10-hour drive down here to see your son play. Well, let me ask you, Mom, what effect has all the success, all the celebrity status from that miraculous turnaround a year ago had on Steve?
Probably the biggest effect that it's had on him is taking away some of his private life, like simple things like going to the mall, going to McDonald's. You know, it's not private anymore. Those things now are people all around him, and that may sound strange, but after a while, that gets to you.
Dad, their publications portray your son as being somewhat flamboyant, cocky, even arrogant at times, but we met him. He seemed very unselfish, very quietly polite, and extremely confident, which is the truth. Steve Tannehill.
Well, I think the young man that you met is the true Steve. You know, I think that Sparky Woods hit it right on the head. When Steve laces up his shoes, it's showtime. And I really think that that's true when you see him out here in the football field and you meet him off the field.
You've been a very successful coach based on discipline, but you're also a father now. You must have mixed emotions when you see Steve's choreographed celebrations on the field. How do you think?
Well, I do, but, you know, this is college. This isn't professional, and these are young people playing out here. They're going to react that way. You know, we've had flags thrown for the first touchdown of a freshman being scored, and you know, too much show. I think that this isn't professional, and you're going to see that, and I think it adds a little bit to the game, as long as it doesn't go overboard.
Thank you very much for coming out and enjoy the ball game.
Thank you.
All right, Jerry, thank you, and Mr. and Mrs. Tannehill. Your son faces a third and five, dumps it. There's the flag down as Pritchett got the first down to the 40-yard line. Now we'll check the penalty. And it's back in the area where you would have a procedure call.
Illegal procedure. Offense. Offensive line was set up on the line. 5 yards from the previous spot. Third down.
So take away the first down. Move it back to third and 10.
Corey Lucci. Number 70, I believe the call's here, Mike, because he's not up on the line of scrimmage.
You're right.
Sinking back a little bit, that's what they called. On the left side, it looked like they were back, too.
Yeah. Well, they'll cheat as much as they can until they get caught. Now they'll go back and line up where they need to be. Third and 10. Three-man rush. Tannehill with a screen to Pritchett. Pritchett dives forward, fumble the ball. Now one official says it is down, and let's see where the mark is. This will be critical.
He's still short, Mike, it looks
about
like
a half a yard where they'll mark it.
It was a late whistle.
Sure was. Everybody was scrambling after that football for a long time. So it's going to be fourth and a yard.
A little middle screen again. Stanley Pritchett working his way for the first down. Ball comes out way early. Mike, that whistle helps South Carolina.
So Simpson comes on to punt with 2:37 to go in the half. Riazzi waits inside his 20.
I don't think I'm getting any Christmas cards from any officials, Bruce.
I have been on the mailing list for a long time myself. Riazzi, no fair catch, and he'll lose about five. And Riazzi saying he was interfered with, that he's got to have some room to catch the football. James Flowers right in his face and made the tackle.
And Matt Riazzi was recruited by Jake Hallam, who's no longer on the staff. It was a walk-on from Kettering, Ohio. You have to like his confidence. I don't see what his argument is on unless he felt somebody grabbed the face mask.
That could be. He certainly had room to catch it. Let's see what Kentucky does with 2:20 to go on the half. O'Farrell remains at quarterback. Wyatt is the deep man in the stack eye. To Wyatt. And Wyatt forced out of bounds near the 25-yard line. That's Pookie Jones. He is the starting quarterback for Kentucky. Has ankle problems on both feet. He is not playing tonight. In his stead, sophomore Antonio O'Farrell. There are the numbers on Pookie Jones. They were very concerned because O'Farrell had not started the game as a sophomore. But the young man has acquitted himself very well tonight. Thrown one bad pass and has fumbled once, but he's run the option offense quite well. Second and seven. Hood, the fullback, pounds ahead to the 29. They need to reach the 31 for a first down.
Key for Kentucky also David with the Hood. Option offense, it rests your defense. You're running the football, you're moving the clock, and you're keeping your defense on the field. Off the field, and you're keeping Steve Tannehill off the field. But here's 1:56 left on the clock. You're 7-7. You like that if you're Kentucky.
And if they get a first down here, they could run out the clock in the first half if that's all they want to do. Third and two. And now Kentucky will have to use the timeout, as Leon Smith was late getting on the field. We'll be back in a minute. In the quarterly report,
Lee Corso really did a good job coaching the stacked eye. He was another coach who used it in Louisville.
Third and two here. O'Farrell did not get the first down. He was stacked up. James Flowers, the man who hit him around the waist, and then Andre Brooks and Brown came up and popped him. But the play was made by Flowers.
You take away the option when you get aggressive and come up the field on the option. James Flowers, number 35.
Check in with Jerry Punch. Doctor?
Guys, you know, speed's so critical in college football. I'm standing with a guy who makes a living at 200 miles per hour. You want an idea what he does? I will show you. Last February, Daytona Beach, Florida, final lap. This young man passed the intimidator, Dale Earnhardt, to win the Daytona 500 in February. And, of course, went on to victory lane. He drives for a very famous man, a man who won three Super Bowls, Joe Gibbs. I'm standing with Dale Jarrett. And, Dale, welcome to Columbia.
Thank you, Jerry. Glad to be here. What a great atmosphere in college football.
You guys watch these games on Thursday nights.
Oh, absolutely. I can guarantee you the guys that are in Martinsville already have their TVs tuned in to ESPN and watching these games. I know I do every Thursday night. There's nothing like it.
You drive for Coach Joe Gibbs. He was known for meticulous preparation as a football coach. How is he as a car owner?
Same way with our Interstate Battery Chevrolet. He wants the car to be right whenever it comes Sunday. Working as hard as we can, Jimmy Maycar and the rest of the crew. And he wants to make sure that we don't have those mistakes and things that cost you championship. He understands things are going to happen, but he's very meticulous in our race car also.
Six races left. You go to Martinsville this weekend. The points race getting closer and closer. What are your chances?
I think we still got a good shot. You know, anything can happen, as we saw last weekend at Dover. We had a good run, got back on track. We've got some good racetracks coming up. I think we can get this Interstate Batteries team back on track and still got a shot at the points.
Dale, thanks for joining us. Thanks for coming by. Good luck in Martinsville.
Thanks, Jerry. Appreciate it.
All right, Jerry, thank you. Nichols got a great break out of that punt. We have 1:21 to go. You know, the great thing about having Jerry Punch here, as a doctor, he can tell us about any of the injuries, and then with all of his NASCAR experience, he can change four tires on that rental car in 17 seconds. That comes in handy.
He's the most valuable.
1:21 to go in the half. South Carolina takes over at its own 37. The Gamecocks out of timeouts. Tannehill under pressure. Carter hit him just as he threw. There is a flag down, and they are going to call roughing the passer.
No, intentional grounding.
Oh,
which I think
that's not much of a call either.
There was a receiver in the area of the football.
Sure was.
Intentional grounding. Cross it out. Stay down.
Now take a look at this. Howard Carter is hitting Tannehill. You can't control a pass after that.
Pressure from the backside. Howard Carter, number 53. But watch where the ball goes. He's throwing it. There's a receiver right in the general direction.
Oh, loss of down and yardage. Second and 24. So South Carolina, let's see if they try to do anything with it. Tannehill comes out throwing it again. Completes the Cates up at the 40. Moore and Stephen Hall, number 14, make the tackle. Well, Tannehill will throw it from anywhere, won't he?
He will. Kentucky's strategy is not let Steve Tannehill beat us deep.
Clock running. South Carolina does not have a timeout. Third and 7. Tannehill with a pump fake. Wants to go long. Cates. And it's overthrown by 5 yards. Stephen Hall, number 14, on the coverage, but they went for it all there.
They have kept Steve Tannehill under control, the defense of Kentucky. Now Kentucky has to think where they get the football. They still have 2 timeouts left, but in their offense, I don't think so.
Do you think block here?
I think you go for the block right here. If you don't get it, then you just kill the clock. Good point.
Kentucky has 2 timeouts left. Simpson to punt. Riazzi, the kamikaze, waits at the 20. They don't come with the big rush. High floating kick. Riazzi signals for the fair catch. And I'll guarantee you, somebody told him to do that on the sideline. That was not his choice. Of course, Jerry was just talking to Dale Jarrett. Be sure to be with ESPN this Sunday at 12:40 Eastern for the NASCAR Goodies 500 from Martinsville. Rusty Wallace has been victorious in the last 2 Winston Cup races and has narrowed the gap on points leader Dale Earnhardt in the battle for the Winston Cup Championship. However, Wallace will have his work cut out. If Earnhardt can finish 5th or better in the last 6 races, he will win his 6th Winston Cup Championship. That's quite a record.
Mike, I think Kentucky just gives the ball to the fullback, the first back in the stack eye.
On the road, tied 7-7. You're pretty happy with that, right?
You should be thrilled.
They'll give it to the tailback. That's Gordon trying to get outside. Slips a tackle. Runs hard up to the 24. About the same thing. No toss on the option.
And they should be okay here and not have to run another play. They shouldn't run another play.
Ernest Dixon made the tackle, and the 25-second clock just started, so unless they choose to, they will not have to run another play. And one of the reasons for maybe not running another play or throwing in this situation, Bill Curry is 1-15 on the road since he has been the head coach at Kentucky. If you have a 7-7 tie on the road, you take it, go to the locker room, and talk about it. Our halftime score is 7-7, and sophomore quarterback Antonio Farrell, 7 out of 11, 72-yard passing, and he has run the option well in the first half. The star of the game, Steve Tannehill, trying to get his club on track. Chris Fowler will be along with the latest in college football after this commercial break. Columbia, South Carolina. Well, Kentucky and South Carolina are tied at 7. Kentucky got off to a good start with a 71-yard drive. They survived their mistakes in the first half, Mike.
They survived self-destruction. 2 fumbles, dropped passes, and penalties. They need to stay with their game plan, the option. It's a 4-corner offense for them now. They're averaging 4 yards rushing the football. 25 rushes, 107 yards. You see to the right side with a pitch, 10 carries, 86 yards.
And the option did give Carolina trouble.
You're going to see Antonio O'Farrell with the option, and now as he cuts, he's able to get the pitch off, and you see the running room for Darnell Gordon.
South Carolina, on the other hand, really seemed to abandon the outside running game. They never got it going.
Well, that has hurt Steve Tannehill because they're only averaging 2 yards rushing, 17 rushes, 33 yards. But you see outside, only two attempts. They have to get the ball to Brandon Bennett outside the tackles on the sweep play.
South Carolina will get the ball to start the third quarter. Thompson to kick off. Bennett and Bridges wait at the 5-yard line. Low line drive kick. Adams. Dumped as he crossed the 20 to about the 23-yard line. Let's take a look at the first half stats. And behind that 71-yard opening drive, Kentucky with a statistical edge in total yards, 179 to 127. But the big number there is the turnovers and the missed field goals.
Turnovers three and another big statistics, 33 yards rushing for South Carolina. They have to use that 33 they have on the uniform number, Brandon Bennett.
Single setback gets the toss, and they try to go outside in the first play, and it works. Let's check in with Dr. Jerry Ponce. Jerry?
Gentlemen, at halftime, the concerns in the Gamecock locker room were primarily the stunts used by Kentucky's smaller and possibly quicker defensive line. The slants, the twists are closing down the inside running lanes. Look possibly for the Gamecocks to tighten up their splits. Sparky Woods told his team the first 5 minutes of the third quarter are critical. We've got the ball, and we've got to move it. Back upstairs.
Jerry's right. They have to get the ball outside. If people are twisting inside, you take it outside.
Second and three. Bennett goes inside. This time, gaping hole up the middle. Bennett to the 45-yard line where Stephen Hall made the tackle.
Mike, I would give him the football until they stopped him. They haven't stopped him outside, and you have to just keep putting it in his hands.
Bennett comes out. DeBoer will check back in. Bennett 12 carries, 55 yards so far. And DeBoer lines up in front of Bennett, 7 yards behind the line of scrimmage. Bennett on the toss. DeBoer, a good lead blocker. Took it to the 49-yard line, gain of four. Deuce Williams in on the tackle.
Just keep giving the football to Brandon Bennett. That will open up Steve Tannehill, what he does best, play action, faking, and then throwing the football.
Now, this is an adjustment, obviously, they made at halftime. Sometimes during the game, it's easy to get lost in what is working and what's not.
Really, as you should be charting what's good for you and what's not, but sometimes when a play's not good, it will come back and be a good play for you.
Second and six, DeBoer this time stacked up. John Collins, number 92, is only 5'10", 255, but tremendously strong lower body. Got in there to make the tackle.
I like Kentucky's defensive game plan. It's not to allow Steve Tannehill to beat me. Not going to throw the deep ball. Throw the short ball. Break up, make the tackle, and keep from getting the first down.
Collins from Madisonville, Mike Archer, the defensive coordinator for the Wildcats, who said this team suffered from a severe lack of confidence on defense because of their lack of history. And he's trying to give them that. He sees it growing every week. Here's the blitz. Screen to Bennett. And Bennett stuck, got away, broke a tackle. Has the first down still on his feet. They had him behind the line of scrimmage on the screen, and the power of Brandon Bennett showed there. And Darrell Kahn was the man who missed what could have been a big tackle.
That was a play that has South Carolina punting the football if you make the tackle. Number 30, Darrell Kahn just is not able to wrap up on the 6-foot, 193-pound junior.
Boy, and then he leveled Willie Cannon, number 33, the cornerback. Tannehill, after softening him up with a run, throws incomplete. It was intended for Matthew Campbell, his 6'5 tight end, but he needed to be about 7'2 to get that one.
Well, you're going to see what Steve Tannehill, when he comes to the line of scrimmage, sees a two-deep coverage, and what you try to do to two-deep coverage is get the tight end down the middle. He knows he has two-deep coverage. He's trying to get that football in to Matthew Campbell, number 86.
Good coverage by the Kentucky secondary as they flew to the ball. Tannehill with time, throws two. Houston, Florida, seven times. And the secondary comes up big again. Robinson, the senior from Richmond, Virginia. And the fifth interception of the year for Tannehill.
The thing that Sparky Woods talked about the other day is when Steve Tannehill throws an interception, I just get away from him because he's so upset with himself, he'll come around. But Steve Tannehill on the drop back pass really gets some good zip on this football, just thrown behind the receiver. Don Robinson with the reception for the interception.
20-yard interception return. The fullback, Hood, as a flag goes down. Hood gets out to about the 42-yard line. We'll check the penalty marker. And Mike, when Tannehill has missed tonight, he has missed consistently high.
He was behind the receiver also, Mike.
Of course, here's a kid.
Holding, offense, 10 yards, pretty smart.
Mac Gentry, the referee, with one of the rare penalties tonight. Tannehill on the phone upstairs, and you really do have to understand the personality of your quarterback, whether you can go up to him after a mistake or leave him alone and he'll take care of it himself.
Well, you don't want to fracture him. You want to build his confidence, but that's a quarterback you don't have to worry about his confidence.
Yeah.
He has a lot.
First and 20. Sparky Woods hoping his defense can get another turnover. Antonio O'Farrell to the shotgun. Comes the big rush, Dixon, and they go to the screen, and the pass is bad behind Michael Woodfort. Let's go to Jerry Punch. Doctor?
Gentlemen, at halftime, I spoke with Kentucky coach Bill Curry, who was concerned primarily about taking care of the football, but the focus in the locker room, two things. That we're going to adjust the way they block the option. They're getting too much pressure on the corner. And also, young quarterback Antonio O'Farrell, recognition of receivers critical. He had some receivers wide open downfield and didn't see them. They work with him at halftime, hope he can get a look downfield and catch some people wide open back upstairs.
Okay, Jerry, and I know Bill Curry doesn't want his quarterback in this situation either. Second and 20. The fullback, Woodfort, nothing there. And the first man that hit him was Eric Brown, number 48, from an inside linebacker spot and just stuck him. Go back to that shotgun, Mike Gottfried. You mentioned earlier they had to block Ernest Dixon. He's just taking that hard outside rush the fourth time he's gotten it out O'Farrell.
Well, they had a good call on because Ernest Dixon is just really beating the offensive tackle. They were able to try to throw the screen on him. Watch the middle guard here just get off the block, Eric Sullivan, 62, and make the tackle on the fullback.
Third and 19. Dixon again coming hard. The pass complete, but for short yardage. Getting out there to Troy Hobbs. James Flowers was on him. And they'll force the punt.
It doesn't look to me like with Antonio O'Farrell at quarterback, you can absorb a 15-yard penalty or 10-yard penalty on first down and make it up. Your offense isn't built that way. You can't afford the holding call.
Nicky Nichols to punt. Corey Bridges waits at the South Carolina 25-yard line. Oh, what a pretty high sailing kick. Bridges, fair catch, makes it at the 24. 10:45 to go, third quarter. 41-yard punt, no return. We're still tied at 7. In South Carolina here in Columbia. Beautiful city, beautiful state capital, and a gorgeous stadium that seats 72,000. And it's got to be, at least in the top three, the loudest places in the country. Bennett. The single setback. Will they go back to the ground game? Little misdirection play. Bennett bounces off of a tackle, sidesteps another guy, and gets it out to the 31-yard line. This kid is a big-time runner, Mike.
He just busts tackles, and he's very dangerous inside and outside.
14 carries, 64 yards. Caught another three passes for 32. That was a gain of 6 at second and 4. Three wide receivers, two to the near side. Same counterplay to Bennett. Picks his hole, has the first down. Mike, it looks with the three wide receivers set, they're trying to spread out the Kentucky defense.
Spreading Kentucky out, running Brandon Bennett up inside. He had good blocking from John Harrison, number 69 on that play. They just need to be patient and stay with the run.
Bennett, the young man who scored the winning touchdown against Georgia with 2 seconds to go in a huge South Carolina win in the opener when they beat Georgia 23-21. Well, you're right. If it ain't broke, don't fix it.
No, you just need to stay with it. The last time they got into the 40-yard line, they got away from it a little bit. They just need to stay with it. Corey Lucci, number 70, the right tackle with a good key block. On number 97, Mike Schlegel sealed him inside.
South Carolina with its best-looking drive of the night to the Kentucky 44. Go with another running back, Pritchett. And Pritchett will get to about the 41. Steve Tannehill, of course, the focus of the South Carolina football team since he became a starter midway through last season. So Mike, I know you like this kid. The negatives, they say, are the fact that he's a hot dog. There may not be enough mustard in the concession stand to take care of him. He's not a pretty quarterback, but he's a winner.
No, he is a winner. Sparky Woods talked about, we'll get it here after this play, a little bit about him.
Second and seven. Reddick to the 30, to the 26-yard line. Mike Reddick, the first rush from scrimmage he's had in nearly a year.
What really made the play was Stanley Pritchard, number 39, with a key block. Stanley Pritchard, number 39, the fullback, with just an outstanding block on Deuce Williams, which opened the play up for Mike Reddick. Marty Moore, false step, just got caught inside on the cutback.
Pritchard is the deep man, room to run off the right side. Moore makes the tackle, but not until he reaches the 17-yard line. Pritchett, 6'3", 235. Back to Steve Tannehill.
Well, Sparky Wood said he's the kind of kid that if you walk in the gymnasium, he'll say, I'll bet you a dollar I can hit the jump shot from the top of the key, and then he'll probably take your dollar. He just really believes himself. No, he's not pretty. He's not a pretty quarterback technique-wise, but he's only a sophomore.
Second and two. Pritchett. And right now, they are doing what Indiana did a week ago to Kentucky. They're just manhandling.
Well, when you looked at the Indiana film, Indiana bloodied the nose of the Kentucky defense, just ran right at them. Now, South Carolina has made the decision just to run the football right after him. A good block on Marty Moore, again, the middle linebacker. Vincent Dinkins, the center, number 73, on Marty Moore, and he just cannot get off the block.
First and goal, and Kentucky will take a timeout. Mike Archer, the defensive coordinator, wants to talk to his ball club. 7 minutes, 11 seconds to go in the third quarter. Mike Godfrey pointed out earlier, time for a little smash-mouth football. If you've got a guy like Brandon Bennett, give him the football. He's gotten it a lot on this drive. Pritchett has carried the football, and it's just been old-fashioned in your face.
And you have a big advantage in your offensive line size-wise. Use it.
Marty Moore has authored many big plays for Kentucky. He'll need one here. DeBoer and Bennett in the eye. Took out two guys that time. What a crushing lead block.
They're making sure they block at the point of attack, but they're also able to get to the middle linebacker, number 45. You can't run under a block like he did there. You never get to the play. Here's the pitch to Brandon Bennett outside. Now, the outside running game is what really has opened up the game for South Carolina.
Rob DeBoer, who turned down Toronto in a six-figure baseball contract to come back and play. Bennett. Touchdown. Cahill pumping up the crowd as if they need it. Bennett on this quarter, 8 carries, 63 yards, and a touchdown. Morton on for the point after. Got it. Cahill waving the towel, getting 65,000 plus on their feet.
Number 31, Rob DeBoer. Fullback in the eye with just a good, solid lead block on Matt Noose to allow Brandon Bennett to get airborne and to get in the end zone.
All Steve Tannehill did on that series, hand it off and lead the cheers. Sparky Woods with his first lead of the ball game. Kentucky scored first on the opening drive of the game. They have not scored since. And Mike Archer trying to pump up that defensive confidence again, which certainly was shredded on that drive. 75 yards, 9 plays, everyone a run. Took nearly 4 minutes off the clock. And do you suppose when South Carolina gets the ball back again, they'll do the same thing?
Right back to running the football. Take a page out of Bill Mallory's book, Indiana. That's what they did to Kentucky last week.
All right, Tannehill, if anybody sits down, he'd point them out.
One thing about that, Mike, you better win if you're going to do that.
That's right.
Because you become a big target if you don't win.
You can pump up your own team. You can also pump up the other guys. But as we said before, that young man is just having fun. That's Randy Wyatt, who was deep to receive. In the first half, South Carolina averaged 2 yards a carry. Second half, 8.4. Browning from the two. Had to get out of his own man's way. Got to the 19-yard line. Hope you'll be with us every Saturday starting at 11:30 in the morning Eastern for College Game Day. Chris Lee and Craig preview all the big games. Then at 12:30, Big Ten and a good game, too. Number 23, Wisconsin against the Hoosiers of Indiana. Then at 7 o'clock, the Residence Inn College Football Scoreboard Show. And at 7:30, we take you to Happy Valley as number 8 Penn State hosts the Scarlet Knights of Rutgers. Maurice Williams in for the first time for the Wildcats, a sensational freshman who could not play in the second half a week ago because of an ankle injury. He is number 10. O'Farrell under pressure, staggered out of the pocket and managed to get a couple of yards. David Turnipseed was the man who forced him to run for his life.
It was a one-man pattern. He was trying to go deep on the post to number 9, Jasuma Sims. But look at the double coverage. South Carolina had the play defended perfectly.
And O'Farrell will go to the shotgun.
Here's where you look turnover if you're South Carolina defense.
O'Farrell rifles complete to his tight end at the 29. Corey Reeves made the catch or had it stick to him.
Tight end just over the middle.
See, about a yard shy of a first down. They have to go just beyond the 29. The ball spotted just beyond the 28. Back to the stack eye. Hood, the up man. Williams, the deep man. Farrell trying to get it outside, cuts it in, dives, he's got the first down. Oh, nice run by O'Farrell.
Mike, that was two tight ends and three backs in the backfield. That could have been played in a phone booth. That was so tight, the formation. Extra effort by Antonio O'Farrell.
The thing you got to like about him, he knew all he needed was that yard, and he was going to make sure when he saw that little seam that he got the yard. And there is Pookie Jones, the normal starting quarterback, who has a couple of bad ankles. Looked good in warm-ups, but is not playing tonight. First down, Kentucky. And they've got about 2 yards the pitch to Williams. Tony Watkins, the strong safety, came up and put him out of bounds. The leading tackler a year ago, the leading tackler this year.
South Carolina really is doing playing well against the option. Now, Kentucky must try to develop some kind of passing game off of the stack eye, either the throw to the tight end or some quick passes, not always the deep pass where you're trying to get behind somebody, but short passes off the option fake.
Williams comes out. Randy Wyatt comes back in. Second and seven. Dixon has pressured O'Farrell six times.
Well, the backup center's in, and it's a high snap to Antonio O'Farrell. And in the pocket, he's just a little short trying to find a passing lane. That should have been intercepted.
Tipped away by Watkins. Third and seven with 4:58 to go. You can certainly feel the momentum has shifted to South Carolina. And 65,000 are on their feet. Screen, Dixon nearly intercepted it. That's the second screen pass he's been a little short on.
What's that old saying? Fool me once, shame on me, fool me twice. Ernest Dixon was waiting for the screen, number 40. They tried it on him early in the second half. Now he reached the screen right away. Now dropped back and almost intercept the football.
So Kentucky will have to punt it away. Nichols kicks to Adams. Returnable punt from the 25. Almost made it outside. Brought down at the 29-yard line. Terry Samuels, the backup tight end, made the tackle, but there's a marker down. 4-yard return after a punt of 42.
Holding on the defense. It was at the line of scrimmage. It'll be a 10-yard previous punt, which will give us a first down.
Oh, what a huge play that is. Before the kick, they get a holding penalty, and Sparky Woods is incensed by that one.
What Sparky Woods,
Kentucky to keep the football.
What Sparky Woods wants is a number. He wants to know who it was.
And I bet he didn't get one.
Is coming out of the head of Sparky Woods right now. He is very upset.
He could light a cigar on his forehead at this point. So Kentucky keeps the ball at its own 43. First and 10. Williams. No dice. Stacy Evans just buried him, the junior college transfer from North Greenville Junior College.
You're calling defenses for South Carolina. Here's what you're thinking. When Kentucky's in the stack eye, there's no threat of the passing game. They're not going to throw the football unless they throw it deep. When they go to the shotgun, they're not going to run it. So now you play accordingly.
Second and 13, and they double covered the single wide receiver every time. Williams, nice catch, and he's wide open on the option. He's got the first down to the South Carolina 38. They got the corner that time, Mike.
It looks like Antonio O'Farrell is more comfortable going to the right. He's a right-handed quarterback, more comfortable with the pitch to the right side. Maurice Williams, number 10. Here's the option. Wide open. You see him limping a little bit. He's still affected by the sprained ankle.
He gained 109 yards against Florida, the first freshman for Kentucky to go over 100 yards since 1984. But as Mike pointed out, he's a little gimpy right now. But this kid is a quality player. O'Farrell slipped a tackle. Ran into his own man. That was the fullback, Damon Hood, who thought the play was long gone. and turned it into something.
For whatever reason, they're having more success with the option to their right side than the left side. One main reason might be Ernest Dickerson.
Yeah. I'd run away from him, too.
I don't think I would. I'd just run a couple plays at him just to keep him honest so he just doesn't take off all the time.
Second and seven. O'Farrell turned a loss into a gain of three. Williams. Nice tackle by Brew Pender, the backup free safety. He kept him short of the first down. Williams from Columbus, Georgia. Went to junior high school in Kentucky. He's quality.
Came down to Georgia and Kentucky for him. Tommy Limbaugh, the recruiting coordinator, stayed on the phone all night with him to talk him into coming to Kentucky.
I'd stay on the phone with him, too.
A couple nights.
Third and two. Woodfork is in at fullback. O'Farrell wants to throw. Intended for the tight end Reeves, and Brew Pender got right in his way, wouldn't let him get to the ball. Great play by the safety.
Third and two, man coverage.
You like the call? I did.
If they pick up the first down.
Yeah.
Here's the play fake now. Man coverage, number 22, Brew Pender sees it. Is able to get off on Corey Reeves, a tight end, so it was covered. Now you have to come back with the option and try to pick up the first down.
No thought of the field goal on fourth and two. Run the option left. And O'Farrell was hit in the backfield. Ball is loose, but it doesn't matter.
That's a smart play by the young quarterback.
Fumbled it forward.
Fumbled it forward on fourth down, but they're not going to give it to him.
They'll mark it back, and Kentucky will turn the ball over. Going down. 14-7, South Carolina.
Okay, here's what you owe us.
If you'll sign right here, it's all yours.
Wait a second, that's a lot of money. We're not signing anything until we know exactly what the payments are going to be.
Yeah, what are the payments?
The payments? Here, try your luck. Give it a shot.
$599. Congratulations, Chuck.
Sound familiar? This won't happen at Sun State Ford. Drive this rugged new Ranger XLT for just $99 a month. Drive it, then buy it at Sun State Ford, where we're not satisfied until you are.
Quiet country setting, that's what you'll find at Palm Valley, an active retirement community with a lifestyle you'll love. With several spacious floor plans and exquisite designer interiors, Palm Valley has a home just for you. Enjoy our large clubhouse with heated pool, tennis, miniature golf, and planned activities. And now Palm Valley's last planned phase is almost full. Hurry, don't miss out on this last chance to purchase a new home from as low as $39.9. Visit Palm Valley just 10 miles east of Orlando on Alafaya Trail or call 1-800-955-7256 today.
Ten is my conference, and I love watching Pac-10 football on ABC. But my husband went to school in the South, and I know how much he misses those classic SEC battles that he used to see down there. I wish I could give him a choice.
This week's lineup features the Notre Dame Fighting Irish against Purdue, only available on pay-per-view in most of the country. For more information or to order, call your local cable operator today.
Welcome you back to Williams Brice Stadium in Columbia, South Carolina. What you're looking at is the latest in fall fashion for the well-dressed Gamecock fan. It's called the Tannehill hat, complete with blonde ponytail. Now, this is just part of the Tannehill mania that's sweeping across the state. Only part of the wardrobe, the complete wardrobe, involves a diamond-studded earring. Fortunately for me, guys, the ear-piercing palace was closed on the way to the stadium tonight. Back upstairs.
Mike, they gave him that hat at 7 o'clock last night. I think he wore it to bed.
It looks good on him, doesn't it?
He won't take it off.
South Carolina, after that defensive stand, will take over. If you're wondering about that fumble on fourth down, only the man who fumbles can recover. A smart play by O'Farrell, but it didn't work. Bennett. And it looks like Kentucky decided to make an adjustment on their defense, too. Tannehill is like a rock star here in Columbia. Of course, the great success and the football passion last year when he came in and won 5 of 6 games at quarterback and really fired this state up. I mean, he can't go anywhere without being mobbed by people. A lot like Mike Godfrey. Second and 10 for South Carolina. Bennett on the toss. And Kentucky has obviously decided they are going to play run. Eric Wright makes his second tackle in a row. Detractors of Tannehill, of course, say he's cocky. His supporters say he's confident. We asked him, which one is it?
The line is so close between cocky and confident. It really doesn't matter to me what people think. I know I'm having fun out there, and I have a lot of confidence, and I have a lot of confidence in my teammates as well as myself, and if that's cocky, I guess I am cocky then.
It's one thing to be cocky yourself, but when you win, you make the rest of your teammates confident in you. Third and 9. Tannehill trying to pick it up here. Throws complete to Reddick. At the Kentucky 46-yard line. Big play, gain of 21.
Good call by Art Wilkins, the offensive coordinator. He ran him on a dash series to the outside to get him away from the twists inside and the pressure. Sprint him to the left. Set him up in a drop back, sprint him to the left, get him away from all the messes inside, all the pressure. You see him sprint to the left side. Now he has more time to throw.
Tannehill, 11 out of 19, 124 yards. He did have the interception. DeBoer, the single setback on first and 10. Tannehill changing the play. Straight back to throw. To Reddick again at the 25. Sandwiched by Stephen Hall and Don Robinson.
It's a smash route. You have a receiver on the outside short, and you have a corner route on the inside. Mike Riddick, 25, ran a perfect corner route.
That time Tannehill saw the adjustment, made the change at the line of scrimmage. See if they get the playoff. They will not. That is the end of the third quarter. South Carolina with a first and 10. They already lead 14-7.
State Farm presents the rules of the game.
We're talking about defensive offsides. In this play, the defense jumps into the neutral zone before the ball is snapped. What is the penalty?
I'm State Farm agent Jeff Libby. One of the most gratifying parts of my job is helping young parents, people who are just beginning to understand what life insurance is all about. Young couples don't need a sales talk. They just need to talk to someone who understands them and their life insurance needs. Now, I know what that promise of security means, and I don't believe there's a better promise a parent can make.
State Farm sells life insurance.
We're talking about defensive offsides. In this play, a player is in the neutral zone at the snap. This is a 5-yard penalty for defensive offsides.
Rules of the Game has been brought to you by State Farm. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
In the year 23,012 B.C., Lenny, the traveling salesman, rented the first big round wheel from Thrifty at a nice small rate. Today, you can still get low rates now on cars with four wheels. Simply use your Montgomery Ward credit card at Montgomery Ward Car Rental at participating Thrifty locations. Renting wheels at low prices is nothing new to Thrifty. In fact, we invented it. Thrifty Car Rental, historically known for low rates.
In my line of work, we go through a lot of sheet metal. So I know a little something about replacement parts. Did you know that some insurance companies specify cheap imitation hoods, doors, and fenders for GM cars and trucks? It's true. And a lot of that cut-rate stuff doesn't measure up to GM standards. Facts are all right here in this free brochure. But take some advice from a guy who's been through a fender or two. Ask to see your repair order before insurance work begins and insist on genuine GM parts.
Someone very special is on that train. That's why you're driving a Buick LeSabre. You love its powerful V6 engine, anti-lock brakes, and steel safety cage body unit. But you bought LeSabre for the dual airbags. One for you, and one for that very special person who sits next to you. LeSabre from Buick, the new symbol for quality in America.
We start the fourth quarter with South Carolina leading Kentucky 14-7. They have the ball at the Wildcat 24-yard line, first and 10, and it's been a big half for the South Carolina offense. They have dominated Kentucky by more than 100 yards. And South Carolina, with 154 yards in the third quarter, they only had 127 in the first half. Bennett, the single setback. Again, they spread the Kentucky defense. Bennett, misdirection. Marty Moore got a hand on it and then got some help from Howard Carter, number 53.
Well, they're trying to wear down the Kentucky defense. They're using the second offensive line in this whole drive. Art Wilkins moving his second group in. Here's the second offensive line as they come off the line of scrimmage. Good blocking. Brandon Bennett on the counter play. Marty Moore on the tackle.
Boy, what a luxury when you can come in with a second team offensive line and they can help you move the football. Bennett, 21 carries, 102 yards. Last week, 127 receiving, 129 rushing. Draw play. Gain of 16.
They hit him on the blitz, Mike. They brought both linebackers to the field and they ran the draw backside. You're going to watch the linebacker, Marty Moore, 45. The blitz is called, but the problem is Brandon Bennett reads it and breaks it backside on the draw. An excellent play call by South Carolina.
Bennett has rushed for 84 yards in this half alone. He has 118 for the game, first and goal. Bennett again. Big hole. Closed in a hurry. Noose got there along with a strong safety, Marcus Jenkins, the transfer from Long Beach City College.
I was just watching Steve Tannehill. After the play was over, after he gave the football to Brandon Bennett, he turned right away to the coaches and wanted his play called. Whatever he was able to see on that play, he wanted to call it on this next play.
Second and goal from the five.
Now the first team offensive line's back in.
Bennett tossed sweep. They strung it out, and he had got maybe a half a yard, and it was Matt Noose again in on the tackle. Nice job by Kentucky.
Good job by the linebackers, Mike. You're right. They're scraping down the line of scrimmage. Matt Noose was able to keep his shoulders square and make the tackle on Brandon Bennett.
And South Carolina wants a timeout on third and goal from the four. And Tannehill sees the signal from the sideline and takes it. 13:07 to go in the ball game. South Carolina by a touchdown.
Buttery soft leather seats, designed to withstand 30-mile-an-hour rear impacts. An adjustable steering wheel wrapped in leather, mounted on an energy-absorbing column. And exotic wood trim, layered with aluminum to prevent splintering. Unlike some other cars, at Mercedes-Benz, luxury is more than a mere facade.
Murphy, that package you sent to Denver, it never got there.
Run.
Introducing tracking software from Federal Express.
It was picked up at 5:20 last night. And it was delivered at 9:42 a.m. and signed for by Kate Donovan. Shall I call her for you, sir?
Never mind.
Now you can track packages right from your computer on your desk. This year during the World Series, Budweiser will bring you the game within the game. The Budweiser World Series Classic. To play, go to your favorite store, look for this sign, and pick up an official game card. Then catch the Budweiser Classic play during each game of the World Series. Each one's worth $100,000. Who knows? You could make the greatest play of the series.
Nice catch.
ESPN's Thursday Night CFA is brought to you by Budweiser. Fresh, pure, natural. Proud to be your Bud.
Williams Brice Stadium in Columbia, South Carolina, where the Gamecocks lead the Wildcats by a touchdown. 13:07 to go. The biggest series of the game right here as South Carolina has the ball, third and goal from the four. DeBoer is the single setback. Two tight ends, two wide receivers. Bennett is not in there. Great coverage by Marcus Jenkins. It was intended for Chris Alford.
South Carolina went to a trips set, kept the tight end in backside for good protection. Steve Tannehill just trying to find the throwing lane, just a little low. It was there.
Good coverage by Jenkins.
Three more points will really force Kentucky out of their offense, their option offense.
We have had three missed field goals tonight, one by South Carolina, two by Kentucky. Morton will try this one. 21-yarder. Got it through.
By Reed Morton. Carolina 17, Kentucky.
So a good drive, and South Carolina salvages the field goal out of it to take a 17-7 lead with 12:58 to go in the game. And you're right, Mike, that 10-point spread makes Kentucky score twice, and they'll have to find a better way to move the ball.
They have to come out now offensively. If they stay in their stack eye, they have to find a way to throw the football. Now, if they go the other route to the shotgun, they have to find a way to run the football to keep them honest.
Let's check in with Jerry Punch. Doctor?
I'm with a young lady who is very proud, not smiling right now because of what you just saw a minute ago, but guess whose mom she is? Remember, number 45 there on the front, Marty Moore, an outstanding middle linebacker and Butkus candidate. Carol Ruck, and Carol, you're awfully proud of your son, but for more reason than just football.
Oh, yes. I'm proud of him because he's doing well academically at Kentucky.
You know, they told him when he came to school he had dyslexia. A lot of people said he couldn't make it, but you said you don't know Marty.
That's right. They didn't know Marty. Marty's dedicated, and I knew when he came here he could make it.
Have you missed many games his 3 years he started?
No, only when he was a redshirt freshman. This is the only games and one game at Florida that I didn't get to.
You know, Coach Mike Archer, defensive coordinator, paid him the highest compliment. He said, you know, I would like my son to grow up to be just like Marty Moore.
Well, I appreciate that. I'm proud of him.
You should be very proud, Mom. Back upstairs.
All right, thank you very much, Jerry. That's Randy White, a couple of yards deep. And they'll start at the 20. Our Thursday night series of college football continues next week. All starts at 7:40 Eastern with a kickoff show. Chris Fowler, Lee Corso, and Craig James will preview the entire weekend for you. Then we'll be off to San Diego as Marshall Faulk of the great stats in previous years, not necessarily so far, will lead San Diego against the Bruins of UCLA. And they've gotten off to a slow start, hoping to correct themselves this weekend.
And they play Stanford, so a tough test for Terry Donahue and his team this week.
Williams is the tailback. They'll need to get him on track. Woodfork, the fullback, will take a couple yards. And there is Pookie Jones, the junior starter who has not played tonight. Really hobbled a week ago against Indiana. And Antonio O'Farrell, who played particularly well in the first half, faces the second and eight. Goes to the shotgun. Rifles it over the middle, complete, and then fumbled. Dropped by Terry Samuels, the former fullback. It's called incomplete. And O'Farrell put it right in there. When they look at the game films, it's really going to be tough to blame Antonio O'Farrell for the lack of offense.
Well, that ball was right on the money, but again, when they're in the shotgun, they're throwing the football. So South Carolina has a little bit of an advantage here on third down.
O'Farrell in this half, 2 out of 9, only 11 yards. Big third down here. With time, he throws complete to Browning, and Browning has the first down up at the 35-yard line. Tony Watkins made the tackle, and that young man has a much better arm than we were led to believe, doesn't he?
He does. He's 5'10". Now, you're going to see him in the pocket. Now, you're the quarterback, Antonio O'Farrell, and here comes the rush. At your 5'10", he gets hit after he throws the football by David Turnipseed, number 91.
Back to the stack eye with Randy Wyatt, the deep man. barrel and the keep to Wyatt. He's free. Wyatt's going to go all the way. Can he be caught from behind? Touchdown. 64 yards for Randy Wyatt. Reggie Richardson nearly made the saving tackle. What makes this play, Mike, is your secondary has to come up and take the pitch. Watch number 22, Brew Pender. He gets caught inside. Now, the pitch man, he has the responsibility for the pitch man. There's no one outside. It becomes a foot race for Randy Wyatt and Reggie Richardson, number 20. Kentucky wins the foot race.
Leonoff for the point after knocks it through. We are back to a three-point game. So a 64-yard burst on the option makes it a ball game again.
It's chasing after something you may never catch. It's hit or miss. And some days it's more miss. It's disappointing. It's dangerous. It's never, ever boring. In other words, it's exactly like a cowboy's life. At Wrangler, we know cowboys. Our jeans were invented by them. Wrangler, the Western original.
This is your world. Genuine and true. Working together in all that you do. And you're giving it your best.
Proud to be your bud.
Budweiser.
Proud to be your bud.
Buttery soft leather seats, designed to withstand 30-mile-an-hour rear impacts. An adjustable steering wheel wrapped in leather, mounted on an energy-absorbing column. And exotic wood trim, layered with aluminum to prevent splintering. Unlike some other cars, at Mercedes-Benz, luxury is more than a mere facade.
Next Saturday, the Scarlet Knights of Rutgers tackle Joe Paterno's Nittany Lions. Live CFA football, Saturday, 7:30 p.m. on ESPN.
Here is Brew Pender, number 22, a young man who made a couple of big plays earlier in this ballgame, got burned on the option on the last play. 64-yard run, Wyatt for Kentucky. He's in on the kickoff team. Exactly what Kentucky had to have, the big play. And Benninger deep. Adams from the four. Got a seam. Adams to the Kentucky 39. Dan Thompson, the kicker, had to make the tackle. How's that for an answer?
Let's go back to the touchdown, Mike. Brew Pender, number 22, the option's going to come this way. He's the person who has to take the pitch. Number 22 will come up, but he comes inside. He takes the quarterback inside. That opens it up for Randy Wyatt, the Louisville transfer, to get to the end zone.
57-yard kickoff return by Adams puts the ball at the Kentucky 39. Going absolutely nowhere. And it was Mike Schlegel, number 97, who stayed home, read the play, and dumped Corey Bridges for a loss of 12.
You get a big kickoff return, then you come back and you get a bad play, and Mike Schlegel, number 97, makes the play. And now if you're Kentucky on defense, you've got to press like Rick Pitino in basketball. Press the offense.
What makes me wonder about that? So successful in just a power game, and they try to trick him on it. So it's second and 22. Tannehill, screen to Bennett. Boy, he threw that ball in a hurry, really before the Kentucky lineman had a chance to clear the line of scrimmage and give him any pressure. Robert Stinson, number 94, out of Cadiz, Kentucky, made the tackle.
That's down by Murray, Kentucky. C-A-D-I-Z.
Where you used to coach.
Final score.
10:33 to go in the ball game. Third and 21 for South Carolina. 1 yard into their own territory, leading by three. Tannehill. Forced out of the pocket. Forced out of bounds by Roger Stenson. And that will bring up fourth and long.
Boy, the defense hung tough and was able to take him out of field goal position. What a key. They had the ball on the 39-yard line of Kentucky and end up back on the 43, 44-yard line.
That was huge. One first down there in field goal territory, but they couldn't get it. Simpson to punt, and Riazzi waits at the 10. Remember earlier in the ballgame, Riazzi would not make a fair catch no matter what pressure he was under. And then you could tell he was ordered from the sideline to make it. A beautiful punt here. Riazzi comes up, makes the fair catch at the 19-yard line. Kentucky really dodged a bullet.
Well, they played confidently. Mike Archer, the defensive coordinator, said they lacked confidence on defense, but last week against Indiana, they made a big play in goal line series, and he said he thought the confidence grew a little bit last week against Indiana.
Well, they've made a couple of good stands here, eating up on a couple of long drives on the ground, but it appeared that South Carolina did them a favor on that last series. Maurice Williams in at the tailback. They'll give it to Browning, the wingback, diving ahead to the 25-yard line. Gain of about six, covered by Brew Pender.
Second time they've run that play, and it was successful both times because of the misdirection of the stack eye. Two players go to the left, and your counter comes to the backside with Alfonso Browning.
Now, Mike, almost every option to the right side has been successful. The ones to the left haven't worked at all. Right now, the right is the short side on second and four. O'Farrell tosses. Nice catch by Williams. He's got the first down. It's one of the few times it's worked to that side. And Williams has got some nice hands.
This is sideline to sideline football. Antonio O'Farrell with good patience here to the left side. Try to make him force the decision. He kicks it out the last second. Mo Williams did a nice job of waiting for that football. He never gave up on the pitch.
Williams, five carries, 35 yards. And, Mike, this is the kind of offense that can tire out of defense, isn't it?
Tire out of defense. Kentucky got the big play, which they needed out of the option in the last series.
Wide side of the field to the near side. They like to run it right. Instead, they go back the other way with Williams. He barely got the handoff as Antonio O'Farrell took a step one way and then had to lunge back to get the handoff.
Mike, because of the big play, the option where Randy Wyatt took it for the touchdown, now Kentucky's back in their offense and now feeling very comfortable because they're trailing only by 3 points. The clock is on their side, 9 minutes to go. They need a long drive here and stick it in for a touchdown to win this game for Bill Curry.
Second and three. Give it to the fullback trying to get the first down. Damon Hood, he was pushed back. His initial progress about a yard shy of a first down. Jamal Pettiford, the initial man of the stop. Both of these teams are in the Southeastern Conference Eastern Division. And here are the standings. Kentucky, remember, barely lost to Florida. South Carolina 1-1. Kentucky 0-1. Big game for both ball clubs. You look at their calendar at the beginning of the year, they both expect to win it. Third and short. And the fullback, a little fancy step for Damon Hood. He's got the first down.
Well, if you're Miles Aldridge, now the defensive coordinator of South Carolina, you really have to get your linemen active in the 4-3 defense. Ernest Dixon, let's keep our eye on Ernest Dixon, who's the playmaker. There's Miles Aldridge calling the defensive signals to the South Carolina defense, longtime assistant for Danny Ford. Number 40, you look for you in key situations with 8:03 on the clock. You look for your playmakers to make plays.
Damon Hood was very slow getting up on that last play after picking up a critical first down.
Do you think it's in the mind of the Kentucky players, the road record?
Oh, sure.
Without
one
a doubt.
15. Michael Woodfork, number 43, in the fullback.
keeper dives forward to midfield. Made some excellent decisions on the option. Bill Curry has done very well at home at Commonwealth Stadium, but on the road, 1-15. He admitted that it starts preying on the mind of everybody, and he said he'd never had that problem before. Always done well on the road after he established the Georgia Tech program and then at Alabama. Second and five. Woodford. Not much there.
Michael Woodford.
Interesting story, Mike, was when he was at Alabama, Don Lindsay, his defensive coordinator, on Thursday before they went to LSU, he gathered up his defensive troops. He said, we're going to LSU. We're going to Tiger Stadium. 87,000 people. The Tiger, everything's going to be exciting. And he said, one of the players in the back of the line raised his hand. He says, Coach, the Tide doesn't lose at Tiger Stadium. He said, they went back, read the press guide, and they hadn't lost there since 69. So a little different confidence level with Bama.
Yeah, they're not used to losing anywhere. Third and three. It has been an impressive drive for Kentucky, but this is the biggest play of this drive with 6:42 to go in the game. They run it right. Williams broke a tackle and has a first down. Top run for Maurice Williams. The freshman from Columbus, Georgia.
Ran right out of the tackle of Ron Neely, number three. Now, here's a tailback that's been sitting on the sidelines most of the night. Now he comes into the ball game with a sprained ankle. Watch him run right out of the tackle of number three, Ron Neely. Strong lower body by Mo Williams, number 10.
Got it by a yard, and Kentucky has done a great job on first down. 4 yards or more, 15 of 27 times. Farrell, they want the end around. They got it. Jasuma Sims with blockers and couldn't stay in bounds. Stepped out of bounds at the 34-yard line. That's very close to another first down. What a time for that play.
That's like a pass play in this offense because you're not throwing the football in this offense. So the way you slow down pursuit is by a option reverse. You see the pursuit all flying. Now they've got this set up. Ernest Dixon, number 40, is caught inside, but a good play stopping Jasuma Sims, number 9.
It's second down about a foot. Woodford has the first down to the South Carolina 32.
Tell you, there's nothing, there's no mystery in this part of the ball game. It's the option and the running game versus the defense of South Carolina. There's no secrets now.
This is very much like that very impressive South Carolina drive where they decided to play smash mouth that said, this is what we do best and we're coming at you.
And that's what Kentucky's decided to do on this series, but they need key plays on first down.
49 yards on 10 plays, all on the ground. O'Farrell changing the play. They go with a counter. Browning, the wingback. Shifty runner down to the 25-yard line.
That's been there all night for him, the counter play. And I think about the option when Barry Switzer was running to Oklahoma. It looked like the wagon was always running downhill when I was on the other sideline. But you need patience in the wishbone offense. Here's the blocking by the Kentucky offensive line for the counter. See how they catch people inside. Ernest Dixon really took himself out of that play. Number 40. Ball step.
Second and three. Again, O'Farrell calling the play at the line. Keeps the ball. 15, 10, 5 to the 1. Antonio O'Farrell.
Alfonso Browning, who's the middle back, number 86, on the load again. Now, you got to credit Kentucky. They've done some nice jobs with the blocking schemes. Number 89, Corey Reeves, the tight end, working downfield on the safety, really opened it up for the big play.
Boy, they planted some people on that one. Woodford, the up man and the stat guy, first and goal. Woodford dives, touchdown! Holy cow, what a drive by Kentucky.
There's two things that go through a head coach's mind now on the Kentucky side. Number one, you know, excited about scoring, but, you know, we've left 4:55 on the clock. Now Mike Archer in the defense really has to be able to take over the game. Michael Woodford really extends himself to break the plane. It's close, but
close. The point after, and a big one it is, because it gives Kentucky a four-point lead. Now it's going to be up to Tannehill with 4:55 to go.
It's 93 closeout at your Central Florida Pontiac dealers, and now is the time to go for it. Yes, the hottest selling cars in the country have all been drastically reduced to make room for the 94s. Big savings and huge cash backs on Grand Am, Grand Prix, Sunbird, Transport, and more. Loaded 93 Pontiac Grand Ams, now just $199 a month. 93 Grand Prix, now just $259 a month. Loaded 93 Bonnevilles, $299 a month. Looking for a great deal? It's 93 closeout at your Central Florida Pontiac dealers. Go for it.
It's the place to catch some of baseball's first pitches, and where people love to throw themselves into the game. But the town of Sarasota, Florida, is also a major financial center because it's served by Nations Bank, which lets Albert and Fruit Company pick from the widest range of commercial services, gives families like the Piles greater investment options, and helps people keep all their bases covered in Sarasota and in 1,900 other communities throughout our nation.
It's time to get serious.
The Yankees and the Blue Jays get serious as they face off head-to-head for the AL East crown. Tomorrow, live on ESPN Friday Night Baseball. This week on College Game Day, Miami's defense. How will they stop the explosive offense of Colorado? Plus, the inspiring rags-to-riches saga of Buffalo receiver Charlie Johnson. College Game Day on ESPN.
Very exciting football game in Columbia, South Carolina. Kentucky has just taken the lead over the Gamecocks with an impressive drive. All on the ground, 81 yards, 13 plays, and they take a 21-17 lead, trying to win their second road game in 4 years. Adams and Bennett are deep to receive, and they go with the squib kick. Taken by one of the men at the 30-yard line, and that's where South Carolina will go with it from the 30.
Mike,
a lot
now,
of time, Coach.
Yeah, if you're Sparky Woods now you want two things. You want to still continue to run the football with Brandon Bennett. You want Steve Tannehill on play-action passes. You want to stay two-dimension here because you got 4:50 on the clock and two timeouts. It's no time to panic. It's time now to just get a good drive and go down and win the game. If you're Kentucky, there's thoughts of the Florida game has to be in your mind, but they just got to play good, sound pass defense.
Bennett has rushed for 118. Tannehill has thrown for 146. Bennett, the deep man in the eye. He'll get the carry. Stumbled a little bit, stood up as he got to the 32 and planted there. Crowd of 66,000 here at Williams Brice. Here's the storyline. O'Farrell, in the first start of his career, led 2 fourth-quarter touchdowns, South Carolina. Tannehill with a 1 interception. Bennett with 153 total yards, his second huge week in a row.
All those 66,000 in this stadium feel like Steve Tannehill will take them back, too.
Second and 7. Tannehill with time. Complete over the middle. Big catch by Toby Cates, who went up and got it.
One thing about it, you're confident, it not only rubs off on your football team, but it rubs off on your fans, too. They're confident in number 18.
And guys like Tannehill love this situation.
It's a challenge to him. He stands right in the pocket, delivers the football, gets a late hit. Howard Carter, number 53, in.
Remember two things. Kentucky lost to Florida on the last drive. South Carolina beat Georgia with 2 seconds to go. Bennett, lot of running room. Kentucky has it. Marcus Jenkins comes out with the football. And Bennett, running hard, just coughed it up at the end.
Darryl Kahn, number 30, strips the football away from Brandon Bennett. This is a give. He has so much running room, extra yards, a good play call. Number 30 There he is. He reaches in, gets the point, gets the arm, really, and pulls the arm back and caused the fumble. Marcus Jenkins, number 13, recovers. Another look. Watch him pull his arm back, slide the ball out. Fumbled now. Kentucky with the football needs to cut the first down.
A couple of first downs, and it's over. The fullback will get about a yard. South Carolina has two timeouts left.
Have to spend them right away, Mike.
There's the first one with 3:41 to go in the ball game. Kentucky by four, trying to hold on to the ball. Having Kentucky over South Carolina, and Brandon Bennett hoping for one more shot. His fumble has given the ball back to Kentucky's rushed for 132 yards tonight, received 32 more yards. South Carolina with one timeout remaining.
Mike, you might think, if you're Kentucky, you might think of that counter play again, the number 86, Alfonso Browning. Safe play.
Second and 10. There it is. Browning back to the left side, but wrapped up this time. Stacy Evans was right there. Landry was also in on the tackle. They will use their last timeout here.
Well, Miles Aldridge thought of the same thing. Because what you're looking for now, if you're Kentucky, is safe plays to run the clock, but you still try to pick up the first down. Now, here may be a play where you want to run the option, but you tell the young quarterback, hey, keep it. Run the option, come on outside, look for the keep up inside, keep the football.
Well, what they have, the wide side of the field is to the right where they have had their most success running the option.
Well, if you're going to be an option team, you got to be with 335. You can't be afraid of this option of football.
No, it's what got you here, huh? SportsCenter following our broadcast. Dan Patrick, Mike Tirico. We'll take a look at the Giants against the Astros, the Braves against the Expos, Greg Maddux and Dennis Martinez. The scheduled start is there. And Sydney, Australia in an upset over China with the 2000 Olympics. Beijing heavily favored by a lot of people. Human rights concerns may have been what finally did them in. But Sydney, Australia, with a great-looking opera house, will get the game.
Somewhere in between the Kentucky-South Carolina game and the Rutgers-Penn State, I missed that.
Well, you live football during the season, don't you?
I'm ready to head to Happy Valley.
South Carolina with no timeouts. They can't stop it again. Kentucky facing a third and eight. The situation here, if Kentucky can convert this into a first down, they may have wrapped it up.
South Carolina will try to tackle the football, try to pull it loose.
Play clock is down to 2 seconds. O'Farrell with a pitch to Williams. Forced out of bounds at the 48-yard line.
That's the problem. That's the problem when you run the pitch, that you can get knocked out of bounds. Norman Green was able to knock him out of bounds, Mo Williams, and stops the clock. So now that's an advantage. That's like an extra timeout for South Carolina. So Steve Tannehill is going to get his hands on the football again.
And 3:29 to go in a game. That is plenty.
Yeah, because that clock would continue to move. You're going to punt the football. Young freshman running back.
Corey Bridges back to receive the punt. Beautiful high kick. Signals fair catch. And it's killed inside the 10. Great kick by Nicky Nichols when they absolutely had to have it. 43 yards killed on the natural grass here in South Carolina. If you're a quarterback with that much confidence, you can't ask for much more than this. 91 yards to go, 3:17 left. You get a touchdown, you win. You don't, you lose.
Well, it's just like that story about the basketball where you had the ball at the top of the key, shoot the jump shot. Is he going to take your dollar now, or is he going to lose a buck?
Everybody on their feet. Pritchett is the single setback. Tannehill pumps, directing traffic. Throws, right, takes it, first down, out of bounds. 31. Check in with Jerry Punch, doctor.
After the last possession, Steve Tannehill came to the sideline to console Brandon Bennett. He got on the phone upstairs with the coaches, got off the phone, walked directly over to Toby Cates, said, Toby, it's me and you, big guy. We're going to win it. You get free. The ball's coming to you. I'm going to find you. Number 12. I'm looking for you. He walked away. Now they have a chance with the ball back.
I got to say. Gain of 21, Jerry. Tannehill.
He got rid of it to Reddick. And it will be an incomplete pass.
Zane Bean, number 59, was in on him. But if you're Kentucky now, you still have to heat him up a little bit. Can't play too soft in the secondary.
They nearly got the sack on that one. Clock stops on the incompletion with 3:05. I don't know how you coach. I don't know how anybody coaches and goes through this on the sideline. This is torture.
A lot of fun.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you see a lot of guys smiling down there, don't you? Tannehill chased out of the pocket. Under pressure. Throws over the middle. Caught by Chris Alpert. Marty Moore all the way downfield. The middle linebacker makes the tackle, but it's 37 yards.
He's the conductor of this orchestra. It's not pretty, but he gets the ball downfield.
Robert Stinson was putting the pressure on, but he couldn't get there. Oodles of time left. 2:54 clock rolling. Tannehill to throw again. Throws short, Reddick. Out of bounds. Stops the clock. He gets out of bounds to 27. Now, Mike, you've got time to run the ball.
You're right now, Mike. You have both dimensions now. It seems like he wants to go to number 25, Mike Reddick.
Reddick has been the pass receiving specialist at the tailback spot. Then they put him out as a wide receiver in the slot. Second and three. Reddick goes to the slot on the right along with Bates. Means to the left side. Bennett's the deep man in the eye. He'll get the carry. Excuse me, Pritchett. Pritchett to the 16-yard line. Another South Carolina first down.
You talk about emotions now, Mike, on both sidelines.
First down, South Carolina. A field goal doesn't do them any good. Pritchett, the single setback. Tannehill in the end zone, too high for Cates. Covered well by Stephen Hall.
Well, Jerry Punch talked about the fact that they were going to try to go to Toby Cates. Number 12 is going to run a post route. They were going for all the marbles. Just a little bit too high. Well covered by Stephen Hall, number 14. The strength of this Kentucky defense is the secondary.
Second and 10. Interception for Kentucky tonight. And that may wrap it up.
I think the orchestra is through playing tonight. If Kentucky now should be able to kill the clock, but you talk about a comeback. Steve Tannehill was bringing his football team down the field. Rolls a little bit to the right side. I don't think he ever sees Marcus Jenkins, number 13, just he was able to come from the backside. Again, he was trying to go to Toby Cates.
Jenkins with an interception and a fumble recovery tonight. The third South Carolina turnover. And I think you're right. Tannehill never saw him until he made the interception. 2:13 left in the game. South Carolina with no timeouts. O'Farrell on a busted play. Just keeps the ball and gets about 7 yards. Out to the 27-yard line. The only time the clock will stop now is if they go out of bounds or get a first down.
And they're not going to pitch the ball now. You can bet on that. And what Kentucky wants to do is lay on the ground as long as they can. They run the football, lay on the ground. If you're South Carolina, you got to get up right away because you want that football back. Take the clock down to 2 seconds before you snap the ball.
Right now, if they hold them on two plays, they could force a punt and go for the block. Play clock is down to 5 seconds. And O'Farrell takes it down as close as he can. Williams with the first down out to the 32-yard line. And Kentucky is on the verge of winning its second road game in 4 years under Bill Curry.
It's a big win for Kentucky if they can hold on the other sideline. You see the emotions of the young quarterback. He's only a sophomore. He's a winner. He's confident.
And
that
Tannehill
is
right
a competitor.
Now is crushed.
He's crushed.
He is a competitor. Clock running, 1:13. No timeouts for South Carolina. And if Kentucky holds on to the football, they will win. They go into the tight formation. They'll just kill it. And Antonio O'Farrell made a similar statement that Tannehill made a year ago. Hey, pay me and we'll win. They played him his first career start, and they get their second road win in 4 years. And this young man acquitted himself very well.
The whole Kentucky team has gained a lot of confidence in him tonight. The biggest play was the pitch to Randy Wyatt on the option play, which they needed some type of big play in their offense.
And then after that, O'Farrell on the keeper that got it down inside the 5-yard line and set up that timeout. Or set up that touchdown. Clock is stopped with 41 seconds to go. And now it will wind. The play clock's at 20. One more kneel down, and it will be over. Kentucky with a huge upset here in Columbia. And now tonight's Wrangler Players of the Game from Kentucky, sophomore quarterback Antonio O'Farrell. 10 out of 19 passing for 97 yards, rushed for 60, but more importantly, he ran the option beautifully tonight. For South Carolina, Brandon Bennett, even with that critical fumble, he had a brilliant offensive game, 2 touchdowns, 164 yards in total offense. That's the ball game. Kentucky, a winner here, 21-17 over South Carolina. And Mike, the momentum swung back and forth. I know both of us felt that South Carolina was going to win it at the end.
Well-played football game, both sides. Just a tough ending for the young quarterback, Steve Tannehill.
And Mike Archer consoling the young man at the end of the game. Our final score, Kentucky 21, South Carolina 17. For Mike Godfrey, Jerry Punch, and our entire crew, this is Mike Patrick. Good night from Columbia, South Carolina. SportsCenter is next after this.